No Jumper, coolest podcast in the world. And we've had people telling us over the years, like, oh, you should interview some producers, blah, blah, blah. And we've interviewed some producers, but today we're just fully just going for the gusto. One of the top names in the business right now. Today we got motherfucking Sonny Digital in here.
Chill.
How you doing, bro?
I'm good. I'm just chilling. I'm just working.
I know you were doing my girl Yes Jules' interview before you came here. Is there anything that you covered with her that we should not cover today, or...
I mean, we can really cover everything. You know, it's different audiences everywhere, though. So, you know, like,
right.
You know, like, I'm pretty sure, like,
you got a lot of shit for us to cover. Like, directions we could go.
I know. We was really just skimming over a lot of stuff. I can cuss on here, too.
Yeah.
Just making sure.
Swear as much as possible. You got weed, roll weed, smoke weed, cigarettes, cocaine, meth, PCP.
I got a little bit of weed, though.
Xanax, Percocets.
Hop on that mic, Webb. There's my boy Webb right here.
It's going down.
Heroin, anything you guys want to do, you can do.
We just need some backwoods.
Oh, shit. I actually don't have any backwoods on me. That's really pathetic on my part.
For the first time ever.
Anybody got anything
up there?
None of you girls have blunts? What do you guys even come around here for?
It's 16 girls in the back, and none of them got no blunts.
16 girls in here, and none of them got black backwoods, no blunts, no nothing.
I don't get it. What is wrong with you guys? I probably have some, like, dirty-ass blunts in here.
Or some random rolling papers.
we're gonna need something. Hold on. I might be tripping, though. I ain't gonna get your
hopes. We gotta check the secret stash. Hold on, we might have them on deck.
Oh, shit, I'm tripping.
I knew I was tripping. This why I asked the man for the
backpack. My nigga had them on deck.
I knew I was tripping. I was like, yeah, okay, we good. Let's get this started.
Hey, you been to London and shit?
Yeah, I was just out there.
You get backwards out there?
Oh, man, it's so crazy, bro. Like,
they got the crazy flavors, right?
No.
It's like $25,
slow
right?
Slow it down, B. Let me get into that, bro. Yeah, I was like that. I was wiping my head trying to find them motherfuckers, bro. Like, bro, you'll be so... Like, it was like... it's. I don't know if in London... Like, and you know, like, out the country, you don't really be liking that shit, though, because, like, that shit kind of, like, influenced people to smoke weed, though. So they're trying to keep that, like, at a low and shit, though. So in Paris, they had them there, though. But it's only one dude... One person in Paris that got him, though, so it's like we got to link up with him.
Right.
And we'll get the backwoods and stuff, though, but...
The one guy.
How the fuck
does not everybody else figure it out?
I don't know. I mean, shit, if you smoke backwoods, there's only one person.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's like, shit, I'm in Paris. Who's the one guy here?
And it's crazy, though, because you see Bari and them out there flexing the banana ones.
Yeah, they do got crazy flavors out there now. Yeah. Don't get me wrong, though, but... Man, the craziest time when I did see some backwoods, I was in Germany. You know, all Germany and all this stuff is all in
the European Union.
It's confusing, though, but it's all in the same place, basically, though, really. And I was doing a show, and somebody was in the front of the crowd, bro. This is the first time I seen some backwoods, like, in, like, 2 weeks, bro. Like, he like, boy, they wasn't no English brand. It wasn't any had English on it either. It was like German on it and stuff. And like,
that's fire.
It was only like three left in the pack. I was like, hold on, stop the show, man.
You bring him up on stage?
Nah, I just grabbed the pack.
But he was happy to just let you have it?
Yeah. I after I got done, I chopped it up with him and stuff. And, you know, I was really like, where you get these from? Like,
right. You've been in Europe long enough, you really start smoking with any old guy off the street.
Man, I'm telling you, bro, like, it's so crazy out there. But you know what? After a while, I'd be like, man, I need a real blunt, like, because they be having those spliffs and shit. I'd be like, hey.
Everybody's on the Swiss out there, but they're literally using, like, one-tenth as much weed as you put
in a
blunt.
Oh, my God. I'd be like, it's like a little...
Yeah, just a like little dash.
It's like, man, I'd be like, bro, we in the States rolling real stunner blunts. Yeah, you know, like,
think, holy, I was just in Argentina, man, and like the weed was so bad that I just gave up. I'm like, I'm just gonna wait till I get home.
I felt like I don't smoke like tobacco and shit like that stuff, but like the papers. Backwoods. But I don't smoke backwoods, just the papers around it though. But I feel like out there, I'm like smoking like cigarette, or weed cigarettes or some shit like that. It's like 80% tobacko, 20% weed out there, and like
you get
they
a little
just
head high. That's about it.
It'd be like I need to go brush my teeth again.
You
like
taste it really thick.
Like
that.
Really, like it's not worth it. It's like
when you start smoking weed. Let's just talk about weed for a while. Fuck it.
All right, man. The weed shit is real tricky. Back in like high school, right? That's when it really kicked off, though. But all right, so I got so fucking high one day, bro. Like, it was me and my bro. We had skipped school or something, and I remember this day so vivid. Like, I don't know, my memory's so tarnished and bad, though. But I remember this shit, though. Like, this day.
You blame weed for your bad memory?
No, I just got a lot of shit going on. It's only like certain things I gotta remember, though. But Man, so I was so fucking high and shit, though. So you remember the little green boxes that used to be inside the little, inside the neighborhoods and stuff, inside like complexes, like the little green machines you used to sit on and stuff? Yeah. Man, like.
You're not talking about recycling?
Nah, bro. It's like the little, I don't know. I don't even. Like
electricity shit.
Yeah, I don't
Yeah, yeah, the electrical boxes.
Yeah. Like it was like a universal seat. For the neighborhood, yeah. You know what I'm saying, like,
and like a throne because it was kind of a contest.
It really, telling you, bro. Like, I'm telling you. So I remember, like, we got high as fuck, and then we had went and sat on one of those for a long ass time, long ass time. I'm telling you, like, long ass time. We sitting there just talking. Then I went to my homegirl house, and I was just, I was like, man, I don't want to be high no more. Like I don't know. Like, when you get to that point of don't want to be high,
yeah,
that's when you just go like super high. You know what I'm saying? Like, right. You just get like the maximum like high. So like, I got cotton mouth, and like that was like the first experience. Like, I'm feeling like I'm dying. I feel like my esophagus closing on me and shit.
You're
like,
so high you can't just be like, oh, I'm gonna drink some water.
Bro, I'm trying to drink water, but I feel like the water ain't going down. I'm like, yeah, man, bro. I feel like I'm dying right here. And so I'm like, man. The last thing I remember, I'm sitting on the couch and shit, though. I'm drinking the water. I'm hydrated. I sit on the couch. I'm like, man, I'm too fucking high. Then my friend started doing this Bill Cosby impression with his voice and shit, though. It sounded dead on. And so I literally laughed myself to sleep. Wake up. Still high, bro. I'm like, oh my gosh.
Bro,
like,
you just smoked one blunt?
One blunt. I don't know if this shit was laced or not, bro. I'm like, bro. After that, though, after that experience, though, like, I was just too high for too long. I was like, you know what? I'm going to fall back from this shit. This shit probably ain't me, because if this going to happen every time, like.
That was one of your first times, like, really smoking, like, big kush? Or
you see, it was either I was smoking, my shit was laced, or it was some real gas, or, I don't know. But, bro, I was like, man, that time it had scared me, though, and so I had stopped smoking for a long time. Right. And so, who was doing? We was drinking this shit, though. We started drinking Henny and shit. And so, like, we was doing that for a minute, then. I got back into smoking when I came out here about like 2 years ago and shit, though. And then I was standing at the house with Travis Scott. We was working on the first rodeo.
Right.
And I was smoking Black and Miles back then.
Oh, really? Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
So like, but those was like, those are worse, though. You know what I'm saying? Only reason I was smoking those because those are more like acceptable in society than a cigarette kind of, though. Because
do you think, though?
Because
I see somebody smoking a black, and I just feel like everybody in the room looks at them like, what is with you? Like,
true, but but a black more. It looks like a blunt. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, I ain't trying to smoke no weed, but I ain't trying to be all the way out the loop either, though. Yeah. Then I already had this habit. Like, I had a habit already, though. You know what I'm saying? To like, just like
smoking something.
Yeah, just smoking something. And then when you making beats and shit, though, you know, like, that shit don't help. Like, trying to be creative, you got to do something. Like, just sitting right there. So that was my thing, though. And so what had happened is I went to, when I came to California, that one time we was working on Travis' album, we stayed in the hills and shit, though, right? And so like, going up in the hills is like, it's like when you go up, when you get to your destination up in the hills,
you're gonna
stay there. You know what I'm saying? And so like,
you can't run to the store for some woods.
Exactly. So like, and the way our house was built, it was like you go up the hill and then you in the hills, but then you go back down the hill and the house down there. So it's like just constant hills and like swirls and stuff. You gotta go down and shit and do all this stuff. And the store is right at the bottom of the hill, though. But it was like, it's just too much like to get out the house and shit, though. So it was like, you know, I'm just gonna sit in here and like.
You gotta have one of the like the little homies go run to the store and go do shit.
Man, but we were so locked in the house, though. It wasn't none of that, though. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? It was more like on some like we all homies and shit, though. Yeah. Like, wasn't no runners and none of that shit, though. Right. It was more like, if you need to go to the store, go to the store. You know what I'm saying? Or everybody come and bring shit in. You know what I'm saying? So like, that was what was happening. Like, everybody was coming to the house, though, because they knew what was going on. They was bringing weed and shit, though.
Right.
And so the weed was plentiful there, though. And like I said, as we working and stuff, though, I'm the only person in there that smoked Black and Miles, probably like one of the person, though. And like, we not like mobile. I'm not from there, though. So it's like, and then I don't want to keep on calling the Uber to go up and down the hill and stuff. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's like, it don't make no sense. So it's like, okay, everybody bringing all this weed here. I got like options, like different strands to choose from now. Now I can really see what I like and stuff. So shit, I really just start getting into it right there. Like, I was just sitting in the living room, damn near like a table like this late at night. And, just like one of the first nights, we was just chilling in there. I ain't had no Black and Miles, and they had everything. I was like, shit, fuck it. I just start smoking, and then, shit, that shit just start getting, like, real crazy. So
you describe your current weed usage as real crazy?
Man, it's ridiculous, bro. I ain't even going to lie, bro. Like, for real, we be smoking like a half, like, every day. A half, to me, is starting to look like a 3.5, though. Like, it's starting to get ridiculous. Like, yeah. I'm like, man, like, the way we be smoking, I be like, bro, this shit is ridiculous. Like,
right.
I'm like, man. And then it's like, the more we got, the more we smoke, though.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So we got a lot of weed. The blunts is going to be a whole lot bigger. Right. But if we got, like, a little bit of weed, you're going to start seeing them slim blunts come around. But
remember when you used to buy, like, an eighth of weed and you thought that was, like, an actual amount of weed? And oh, now my it's gosh. Like, that's a blunt or a blunt
I'm
and a half,
telling
maybe.
You, I'm like, bro, like, that's only, like, two blunts, like, for real. Like,
yeah.
Like, if you went, like, man, you really try and get creative and get to it. You know what I'm saying?
People
like,
in other places will buy an eighth and it'll last them a week, week and a half.
Man,
weeks,
I don't so. Understand. I'd be like, I'm like, yeah. How are you this key, like, how are you doing this? Like, I can't do it. You know, the weed dry out and shit, though, too. Yeah. And that shit, it get weird and shit, though. Yeah. Like, but I can't hold on to the weed that long, man. Like,
but, yo, your whole image now is Sonny rolling grams of wax. Are you, like, fully in love with the wax or are you,
you
still
know,
on the flower?
I'm really on the flower still. I'm going to keep it a buck with you, though. But I still fuck with the wax, though. But the wax, it was just, that was just a line that the 21 said, and it was cool. And I do smoke wax, too, though. You know, that's what I was doing around him when he came with the line, though, because I had came back from Cali.
Yeah, yeah.
And my boy Jared had gave me all them little wax packets and shit, though. Yeah. And I had them shits back, too. And so I was putting them on the blunts out here.
Yeah, yeah.
And we was rolling them shits up. And so that's where that came from and shit, though. So, but that wax shit is something different, bro.
Yeah, it's a whole different level.
Yeah, like
that's
like,
some whole other shit.
Like, man, niggas don't understand. Like, I couldn't smoke wax in every single blunt, though. You
right,
know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Then that shit's so messy, too. And that shit be having a nigga goddamn
your morning
like,
blunt, that'll have you on the couch not wanting
man,
to do shit.
Man, a morning blunt of wax is not it, bro. Because the morning blunt by itself, though, that's the one strongest blunt, like, in the whole day, like it's already strong, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't need to amp it up anymore. Like,
I try to put it off. I try to like wake up and be like, all right, I'm not smoking weed until I get this and this done.
Nah.
Well, you're on the fucking MPC making beats all day. You're fucking chilling.
Nah, shit. I need to smoke as soon as I get up. That's the first thing we do. Might knock back out. That shit might put us back where we need to be. Like go back to sleep.
You just rolling out of bed, just lighting up.
Yeah, I mean, if it's there, shit. I mean, but if it ain't there, that's when you got to kind of get up and scavenge around and really get up and be like, let me get
to it.
But that's the producer lifestyle. Is like, if you don't wake up till 5 p.m., it's all good because you know you're staying up till 8 a.m. or whatever.
I don't know when I'm going to sleep. I was telling somebody, like, for real, like, my life, my shit really consists of naps and shit, though. Like,
really?
I just nap for a couple of hours and then.
You don't like to settle in for that full 8 hours or what? Do you like that when
Hell
you get
nah.
the chance? No?
You know, in my house in Atlanta. I be telling everybody, I don't think nobody really believe me though, but it's like three stories in there though. And like, I got my setup at the bottom and like it's the living area in the middle, then the bedroom all the way at the top.
Okay.
The bedroom is just way too far up top of me though.
Right.
And it's so hard to get out the bed already. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, I don't want to go upstairs and be in the bed and like try to like really get out the bed and like try to like it's gonna be hard trying to work my way back downstairs to go work. You know what I'm saying? From my bed. So it's like, let me just stay as far away as possible from that thing, man. Cause it's comfortable too, and it's a nice little view. Like,
so you are able to work out of the house all the time. Is this real important to you? Like being able to just have that consistency. Do you not miss the days of running around different studios and shit?
I take advantage of that when I'm in LA.
Right.
You know, when I'm in LA, that's when I go out to the studios and stuff. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
It's a little more to offer out here though. Like in the studios in Atlanta out there, like, you know, like shit. I'm from there, so you know, every time I go there, I'm always bump into somebody.
Right.
And be probably into some shit that I wasn't meaning on being into there. So like, really, for me to really like move forward and benefit in my career, I do gotta work at home though.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, just so I don't get deterred from what I'm trying to do. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, you know.
Yeah, so that's one thing I'm real interested in with the fucking beat-making process with you is, like, your efficiency and how you organize your life so that you can be so productive because you get a crazy amount of work done. We see your name so much, and I'm just trying to figure out, like, what your productivity is all about and how you arrange your life.
Well, like, it ain't really no arrangement to it. My life really just be going as it go, like... It's weird. Like, I always be thinking about that shit, though. Like, it's almost kind of like, it ain't really no guaranteeing this shit, though. But what I do see, and I know this shit work like this, and the way the world works is as much work as you put in, that's what you're going to get out. Like, because, like, when I actually be going hard and, like, making, like, a ton of beats and shit, though, For some reason, a ton of niggas always end up calling me, and I end up getting a ton of placements and shit, though. But when I slow it down, then, you know, that reflects on the work that come back in, though. So it's like, right. You know, I don't know. It's really on me, I feel like, though, at this point, though, too. And, like,
right.
Shit, the way I built it up, though, I feel like people know I got good beats. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So, like, it's not really, like.
But so when you were a kid,
no question.
When you were coming up in the game, do you credit that you just put in like an insane amount of hours ever since you were a little fucking kid, and that's why you're successful now?
Shit, I think people. All right, so as a kid, shit, when you doing shit, you doing that as a hobby though. You ain't doing it like I'm doing this to work or to live off of this shit though. Like you gonna put your time into it unknowingly and shit though. And that's what I was doing though. You know, like I wasn't playing sports and shit though. That was just my niche. That's my like. My thing to do, you know what I'm saying? My time went into there, like, just me unknowingly doing. I was, like, putting in experience points, like.
From what age?
Early on. Like, what grade is, like, sixth grade? Like,
you're, like, 11, 12.
That's when I can really, like, just remember, like, I'm going to do this shit, though. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I remember one of my boys took one of my beats to school and, like, showed everybody. And they're like, okay.
Yeah, you're making beats in middle school.
Yeah, hell yeah. Fine, I was doing it. I was actually doing it before then, though, but that's, like, a memorable time, like, for me, though. Like, I remember that shit, though. I remember in, it was in Michigan too. Like I remember that too. That's when I knew I was.
That's where
good.
You grew up until what age?
No, I grew up in Atlanta. I was
just born there. Right?
Yeah, my family there though.
What part of Michigan?
Saginaw.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, so that's where my family is though. So
how far is that from like Flint?
Flint, probably. I'm not gonna. Don't get me up here lying though. I don't know. It's not like I don't think everything like just right there. Yeah, or everything at least like an hour out from Saginaw though. You know what I'm saying? Like.
So what age did you move to Atlanta?
That shit, it wasn't my choice. I was a baby.
Not said what age, what like.
Oh no, I was a baby. Okay. Shit, I wasn't grown. I wasn't able to make no decisions and shit though. But I'm glad that I was out there in Atlanta though, cause
for sure.
You know, I don't know how the shit would have turned out if I would have stayed. Yeah. In
so your parents Michigan. Weren't like shoving sports down your throat or anything. They allowed you to be doing the music thing from an early age.
Man, I don't know if you caught my vibe yet though, but I do understand why I act like how I do act though. Yeah. I be chilling, like I be really chilling though. My parents was really just like that.
Really, they were like, very laid back.
Man, when I mean, you know, a mama gonna be a mama though, but it's only like I feel like, you know, like it's only so much a mom can do with the son though too though. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like and it's only so much your dad can do with a son before he make his own decisions and stuff though. You know what I'm saying? But it wasn't like we were bad kids either though. Or we were stupid, like making dumb decisions and shit. Though it was just like they just kind of let us do our own thing. Though like
that's dope.
Like I dropped out of school. And my mom, and my dad, they weren't like really just. I'm not gonna say they were supporting it though, but they wasn't like pressing me though. But I mean, as soon as I dropped out, shit, like I said, I ain't no dumb nigga. So I went and got my GED because I know if I wait like a year later, I probably won't remember none of this shit.
What age did you drop out?
I dropped out my last year of high school.
Really?
I hated school, bro.
Was it because you were doing all right with the music stuff, or was it just because you hated it?
Waking up in the morning, that shit was shitty.
Oh, yeah. What, 5 o'clock and shit?
Man,
oh my God.
I'm like, bro, like, every fucking morning, bro, like, when is this torture going to end? Like,
and you're in puberty, so it's, like, the one time in your life that you're not trying to get up on a schedule.
Man, not to, like, sound bad, though, but when I got my GED, I was like, and I found out how much earlier I could have got out, like, damn, I could have really, like, been out this motherfucker, like, early, like, you know what I'm saying? Like. Yeah. I don't know, man. Like that shit just wasn't for me. I knew I wasn't walking across no stage though.
Yeah,
I was like, man.
But were you starting to feel like you were gonna have a real career in music even when you were in high school? Is it kind of becoming apparent?
Shit. I knew what I wanted to do. You know what I'm saying? But it was like making everybody believe that shit though, type of thing though. You know what I'm saying? Like in high school, I was
about to ask you that. Like, was you like the hot nigga in high school? Where everybody was like, we gotta get beats from Sonny, bro.
Basically, you know what I'm saying? It was already like that in high school. Like in the whole region and shit though. Like in Atlanta, the whole little region. Like I had already been there.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So like when I actually caught some shit though, it was already like that was bound to happen. You know what I'm saying? Because I had already put so much work within the city though. And like, have you seen like when I first came out, the songs I came out on was. From like two unknown artists from Atlanta.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So that shows I was putting work in the city. It wasn't like no known
we're
artists.
You're talking about YC?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. YC and Future? Yeah. You're talking about them as the two unknown artists at the time? Mm-hmm. So, was that, how old were you when that came out?
It was 6 years ago, so.
2011.
So you're like fresh out of high school?
Probably like a year out. I don't know. Went too far out though.
And so, who is Future to you at that point? Like, what's your perspective on him? Is he just like a local guy who's got a little bit of talent?
Man, when Racks on Racks came out, I didn't know YC. I didn't know Future. They didn't know me. We just knew each other through the song.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, I don't know if they knew each other, but I didn't know them.
Future wrote that song, right?
Hey. We ain't gonna go back to the past, man. We just gotta look at the scoreboard, man.
That's all that matters, bro.
Look at the scoreboard. That's it.
That's all that matters.
And so,
things end badly with YC. Is that what you're telling me right there?
Me personally, I fuck with YC.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know about everybody else though. Like, I really, just to be honest though, with YC, you gotta understand, he came through with like a real live banger. Like, it really changed. Yeah. Like,
that was huge.
Man, it was three brand new people coming through the door, me, him, and Future, bro. And we had all that bag to split up and shit, though. Right. You know what I'm saying? It was like, It was a fresh new situation for the whole, like, Atlanta, bro. Like, it was, like, so new, like, that it was, like, bound to get fucked up. You know what I'm saying? Like, it was going to get fucked up. It was so much money involved in the situations and shit, though. Like, and niggas, this shit was so new to everybody, though. It wasn't nobody really experiencing the situation. Like,
right.
I think probably the most experienced person in the situation at the time, though, was probably, probably Rocco, because you know Rocco had the shit with Future and shit though, so
right. That
was probably like, I don't know, like,
because you're not talking about a normal amount of money there when you're on the radio that much. All of a sudden it's a stupid amount of money.
This was like a real life changing song, like, right, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like all the way around, money, everything. Like, it was a life changing that song for everybody though. Like, that shit like got everybody off the ground, and it started so much shit in Atlanta, though, that I don't think that people really realized. Like I said, that was the first time a lot of people had heard Future NYC and even heard, like, that sound and shit, though. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Even, like, anything. You know what I'm saying? Like, that shit was so brand new, and that kind of, like, set the tone for what Atlanta was about to be for, like, that time all the way up until now.
Right. What would you even call, like, the change sonically that song had for the time period? Because it was, like, a crazy new sound.
Shit. I don't know. We was, like, really just...
I'm straight.
Doing our thing. Like, it wasn't like...
It was so playful and light.
Yeah, like...
And it was just...
That's all it was.
So
like,
new,
bro, like, it was so crazy. Like, and that wasn't like the favorite, like, my favorite song at all. That was just the one that just caught.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That I had produced and shit, though. I had did so many other songs, like, with Future and shit, though. Like, that was my favorites and shit, though. So, it was really just...
Did you make that beat in the studio with them, or you just sent it to them afterwards?
Nah, like, at that time, we didn't know each other. Like,
exactly.
At that time, I was staying with Gorilla Zoe.
Right.
Yeah, I was staying with Gorilla Zoe at that time.
Was he, like, your original, like, artist that you were really trying to be, like, the dude doing his projects with him?
I wouldn't necessarily say that, though, but that was the original dude who kind of, like, opened up that door for me to do something like that, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, he needed a producer at the time for what he was doing, and I needed an artist at the time for what I was trying to do, and, like, it all just kind of made sense. And,
right.
Like... Real shit, like, that's my dog. Like, I ain't gonna lie, like, I fuck with him heavy though.
He still raps?
Yeah, he be out there with Flo Rida in Miami and shit. Nice. Doing. He be getting his little bag like on the other, he went. Like,
that's fire.
A lot of people don't know. Like, see, I knew him, so I knew like the inside and shit though. So like I knew how big he can be though. Like, I knew eventually it was gonna get to this though. Yeah. Because, like, people didn't know, like, people knew him for that hood nigga song, that hood figure. But that wasn't even his biggest song. His biggest song was a song called Echo.
Right. Mm.
You know, I don't know if nigga, I don't know if y'all remember that. Like,
I remember his name well, but.
I think so.
Echo. Only reason the shit didn't get, like, major big, though, is because it didn't have a video to it, though. He did all these pop songs. He did all these pop songs and shit, though, which was, like, it was crazy, like, how I kind of seen it happen and shit, though, because, like, he was doing, like, he'll had a song like Hood Nigga, and then turn around, and then, like, he'll do videos to, like, Hood Nigga and all the hood songs, and then he'll have a song like Echo and the other song, and then, like, but people couldn't, like, he didn't have videos to those, so people couldn't, like, really connect his face to that, though, at the time, song, though, and so, like, it was this one song he did, though, now I forgot the name of it, though, it was with Lil Jon, and, like, when people seen that was him doing that and that, they was like, this shit ain't adding up. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
And it makes sense.
And it makes sense though. But at the same token though, like, whenever I talk to him though, I be like, man, look, fuck that shit over there. Like, fuck all that hood shit, man. Yeah, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, get on that other shit over there. You know what I'm saying? You'll be able to, like, really, like, prosper. Like, that shit really projecting numbers over there for you though. That's how I always felt about the situation. Like, I was like, in my eyes, I was like, man, that's my dog. Like, whenever I gave him beats and shit, though, I always kind of leaned over towards that, though. You know what I'm saying? I was like, man, that's where the shit need to go with you.
You just felt like that was more his sound? Like, that was more his, like, his
It portrait. Was. I mean, shit, the numbers don't lie. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? That's what sold for him. You know what I'm saying?
It's that's fire.
That's what's doing well for him, yeah, too,
he getting,
still.
Yeah, he getting that flow rider check. That's fire.
Yeah, I mean, shit, he over there. I be seeing him, too. Like, when I went down to Miami, that's, like I said, that's the homie. Like, that's a big bro. Like, fucks with him heavy. Like, whatever you need anything from me, though. You know what I'm saying? Anything, like. Yeah. Shit, I do a whole mixtape with this nigga today, my nigga. Like, that's yeah, my that's dog fire. Still. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, for real. For
so
real.
You connected with Future over Rax. Do you just then immediately just start working with him like crazy?
Yeah, I my favorite rapper too was Rocco too at the time too. Right, so yeah, you know that it all makes sense though too.
It's a shame how that friendship ended.
Or I don't
presumably
know.
Ended.
Yeah, I don't know if it really ended yet though. You know, like I don't really know. You know what I'm saying? That's just like it's just. You know, like, it's just business, bro.
Yeah,
it's gonna happen, though. You know what I'm saying? You see, it's happening with Birdman, and you know, it's damn near regular now. You know what I'm saying?
Rocco's shit is crazy, though, because he was always like the dude that Gucci would shout out as his favorite rapper.
Yeah.
He was always like right there by everybody who was coming out, but it never really happened for him so much. Well, I mean, it did. Yeah, it hits, but you know.
It did. See, only thing, I talked to Rocco too recently. We was in the club. I was like, I could tell his career, like, he made money, like, other ways and shit, though. Like, this nigga, the only nigga down there in Atlanta, not only nigga, though, but one of the few niggas riding around in the Maybach, and a Ghost, and a Ferrari. Like, he got all these cars, like, but like you just said, he ain't really popping, like, as far as, like, song-wise right now, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, he don't got a song right now, or, like, he don't really, like, have one, like, as consistent as, like, niggas and shit, though. Like, you know what I'm saying? But he always catching one, like, damn near every year, though. But he got other little ventures going on that's, like, just keeping it going, though. And, like really, he got a gang of songs doing. Like, I think people be forgetting. Those shows is, like, boy, them shows will get you rich, bro.
So between Rax and Same Damn Time, how long is that? And, like, how much work were you putting in with Future at that point?
I think it wasn't too long, though. I can't really remember, though, because it wasn't like I was counting the time and shit, though. Like, we did Rax, and I know we had done, like, a whole bunch of mixtapes in between.
Uh-huh.
And then I remember The Streets Is Calling. That was the mixtape Same Damn Time was on.
It took a long time for that to bubble from that mixtape, though.
Yeah.
I remember when Streets Is Calling came out.
Yeah, I remember that shit, too. Because that was down there like another changing point in my career. You know what I'm saying? That was one of them, like, oh, shit is happening again type shit, though.
That's when he became, like, serious artist Future, where people really started to take him seriously. Because on Rax, it's like he's basically doing the hook. It's kind of like, you know, people weren't necessarily thinking of him like he's going to be what he is now.
Not that. You know, niggas ain't know whose song it was in the first place.
Right.
Even to this day, niggas don't know whose song it is. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's still a problem up in the air with that shit, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, but, I mean, now niggas got it, though. And then, like, when Same Damn Time came out, though, like you said, though, kind of, like, just, like,
started to legitimize them.
Yeah, then you got to think about all the in-between, too. All the mixtapes that's, like, that he was putting out that people was, like, catching, like, cool songs. Like, oh, I like this song. I like this song. I like this song.
Yeah.
It was like, damn, they caught the one song. Like, oh, I really like this song right here. You know what I'm saying?
But by the time, like, Streets Is Watching comes out, you're already kind of, like, the popping. Shout out to the homeless people.
Shout out to the homies, homie, with the boombox on his shit.
Crazy.
He's really rocking out there.
He snaps out there. Bro.
He out there living.
We might have to go smack him with a broom if he don't get the fuck out of here. And you can hear the mail slot.
Street sweeper.
Bro, that nigga came through on 10, bro. I heard that nigga.
They love that. They love to just show the world the music that they love. They probably play your shit, like, all the time. That would probably make you real happy.
Man, I need you to come put my shit out here with them.
The homeless guy with a full Sonny Digital catalog playing.
I'm telling you, bro. Some beats out here, man.
Yeah, right.
Happening on all type of shit.
So how are you being, like, perceived at this point in your career, like, around the time Streets Is Watching and stuff? Are you kind of starting to be that guy in Atlanta that everybody's coming to?
This is the thing. In Atlanta, like, I'm just now starting. It's really just now starting to become cool to be that producer and shit, though.
Okay.
But I had already been doing it, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, when Rex came out, my tag wasn't on that shit, though. But I had my tag, though.
Right.
It was just a problem when I was exporting the beat with the tag and shit, though. Yeah. And I was frustrated, so I just said, fuck it.
Was that a huge mistake when you think about it?
Huge
now?
Mistake, bro.
Oh, man, yeah.
Huge mistake. One of the biggest mistakes, man. Like, from that mistake, like, it's like I had to fumble. Like, I fumbled that one time, and, like, ever since that one time, I just been trying to work the motherfucker and get my name solid on these tracks and shit, though. And, like, we at a point right now where it's kind of like niggas won't that shit in it, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, so like,
off top.
And so like, the shit was stumbling so bad. Like, the first one, like when Rax came out, I was exporting the beat. The shit was fucking up. I started exporting the sounds one by one, and the last sound was my tag and shit. And it was fucking up.
Yeah.
I was pissed off, and they had pulled up. I was like, man, I ain't gonna beat without the tag and shit, though.
Yeah.
Shit fucking took off on my ass. Man. You know what I'm saying? Took off on me.
Well, do you have niggas like claiming it, saying that they was their beat or something? Like, just because it didn't have your name on it?
Nah. No, not at that time. That's what happened with that one. That shit took off. I told YC, I remember this shit one time. I was in patchwork. I was like, bro, like, man, I ain't got my tag on here, bro. Just look out for me when you do these radio interviews and shit, though. But really, looking at it now, I was really asking for too much, though, because he was still trying to get his shit popping, though. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so he can't really pop me off. I wasn't signed to him, so he wasn't obligated to do shit for me.
Yeah.
They already paid for the beat. It was my time to go, you know, put in my own little work. And so that's what I did. And so in them future mixtapes, like all them mixtapes and shit, that's when my tags start coming out.
Right.
And them shits and shit, though. And so, like, them shit start weaving through there. And, like, all right, so what had happened was when Same Damn Time came out, right? So it's two different versions. A lot of people don't know this shit. It's two different
the
versions.
Album version, the mixtape version?
Yeah, but
basically,
yeah. All right, it's two of them. It's the mixtape one and the album one. Only reason it's two different versions is because my hard drive had crashed on me and shit, and I had to remake the beat and shit though. Right,
you remade the whole thing.
I had to remake the beat. Like, you played the original one and the remake.
Yeah,
the one on there, you'd be able to tell the difference. Now I'm telling you though, you know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
So, awesome. I couldn't like at that time too. And still to this day, I was like, I be making my beats to like a point to where I damn near can't like remake them bitches and shit though. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I was gonna say, how hard is it to remake a beat?
Oh my god, that beat particularly, that shit was hard as fuck, bro. Like, I couldn't get it on point like all the way. And like, I got another story right after this. Like, it's crazy. Like, what happened? Like, all right, so, like with that beat too. So the original one, my tag was turned up in the original one.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But that wasn't the one that went out to the masses and shit, though. That was the one that was like the original, like, first little ump blast. And when they seen that was the one that was going to be jumping and shit, though, that's when they needed the files and shit, though. But by the time they needed the files, I had dropped my hard drive and the shit was gone. And so, I had to remake the beat. I remade the beat and shit, though, right? And so, motherfucking, that shit come out and then motherfucking... Damn, I just lost track of what I was saying, bro. I was thinking about something else. I just looked at something else.
No, because you're talking about the remade version of Same Damn Time.
Yes. All right, so I just had to remake it. All right, so then, all right, so basically with the tag. All right, so with the tag, and the remade one, I don't know why, but it was like misplaced, or I didn't put it in there, and I sent it separately or something though.
Right.
And when you send it separately and shit though, I'm pretty sure this will happen. I know I sent it separately though, because where it was placed at or somewhere, I would never put it in though.
Uh-huh. Somebody else did it.
Yeah, like the engineer put it in there like the beginning. So like at the beginning, like it's not in a real distinctive place though. You know what I'm saying? The beginning, not a real distinctive place. Like when we put the drop set, it's like. Is what beats is dropping in and shit though, so you can't go over the tag. You know what I'm saying? Wow. Or the tag is in a real prominent place where it can't be moved and shit though. In the beginning, that shit easily get blowed past and shit though. You know what I'm saying? So that was the worst place and shit though. So boom, I kind of lost on that one. Even though my tag was in the Same Damn Time that came out, people didn't hear it though. It was low too. You know what I'm saying? It's at the beginning, so like it wasn't in the place. It was like as soon as it came on, my tag came on. So it was like as soon as it came on, they forgot about it.
Right. Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? It wasn't like that thing. So. Boom, that happened. I was like, fuck.
And then you said you have this other story?
Yeah, so after that, same shit damn near happened again. So I got my hard drive back. Well, I had my hard drive. On this same hard drive, I made Birthday Song. I made that beat, right?
Right.
Oh, shit.
I made that beat, and I had lost that one, too. And on that hard drive, because I made Same Damn Time and the Birthday Song beat.
So
like,
your shit used to be pretty, like, unorganized, I'm guessing?
Nah, it was organized, but I just was clumsy. I'm clumsy. Right. So, all right, so.
You smoke a heroic amount of weed. You gotta forget some beats here and there, right?
Yeah, all the time, bro. Oh, my God, bro. I make more beats than anything, though. Like, I got a lot of beats. That's like, even right now. I don't make as many beats as I used to, though, because I don't really want to have. I don't want to be sitting on that many beats. That should be stressful at the minute.
Right.
But, fucking, yeah, so, all right, so, fast forward. So, next beat. All right, it was a song, the birthday song.
Yeah.
That beat. A lot of people don't know this fact either, though, too. So the birthday song beat was originally a song I had done with Gorilla Zoe.
Right.
On one of the mixtapes we had done, right? And so 2 Chainz wanted the song.
The exact beat or the chorus, or he just wanted?
No. It was the beat. So it was the original beat.
Right.
We had the original beat. The original beat, which is Gorilla Zoe. On it, right? And then 2 Chainz wanted it. So Zoe was like, okay, cool. Then when he did that, 2 Chainz had done this verse for us, right? And a lot of people don't even know about this song, though. And so the song was called All Out, and it was Gorilla Zoe, 2 Chainz featuring and me. And I was on it rapping too. I had been rapping. That was years ago. You know what I'm saying? That's and so I had a song. I already had a song with these niggas and shit a long time ago and shit, though. They had put me on that shit, though. And so, 2 Chainz had got the beat from Zoe and shit, though. Like, it was like on some, like, I'm going to use this, swap it out, you know what I'm saying? No problem.
And Chainz, like, knew he was going to make a huge smash out of this, or?
Yeah, we all knew what was about to happen and shit, though. So, motherfucking, we did that. And then, you remember that year 2 Chainz went to South by Southwest and Kanye West came out?
Yeah, actually, yeah.
That was the same time when he did the birthday song. After he got off the stage, I went back to the tour bus, and my manager was out there. I didn't go to South by Southwest. I ain't fuck with that shit at the time. And so, motherfucking, they was out there, and he had passed them off the beat.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? That's how the beat had got to him originally, and then the Zoe stuff had happened, and then, boom, we fast forward to, like, where the song was, like, being processed and being done now. So, fast forward, send the files off, put my tag in this one and shit, though. And but I remember I had the original beat,
yeah.
the original mine, you know what I'm saying? So my tag fit in there, you know what I'm saying? How it was already structured. And so when I send it off to Mike Dean, and you know Mike Dean and Kanye, yeah. they add their little Mike Dean Kanye West stuff into it, you know what I'm saying?
Because wasn't there like 5 different people that ended up touching that beat before it finalized?
Yeah, another interesting thing. So you remember I told you I lost the beat,
yeah.
So I had to remake that beat too. But that beat was so fucking hard to remake that I couldn't remake that motherfucker, though. Yeah. So what happened was I got another producer that I be using sometime. I had him come in, and, like, he helped me, like, remake the shit, though. Like, I had got some of the shit right, though, but we had to, like, he couldn't even do it. Like, we had to go back in and sample some of the original beat.
Yeah, yeah.
And put it into the new one, you know what I'm saying? So that's how we had got the beat, though, because it was, like, damn near, like, the beat was like, it was, damn, this shit close as hell. The beat was like, it was like fucking weird as hell. It had the weirdest sounds in it, so I couldn't find the sounds and shit, though.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it was like, it was a headache, so that's why we had to sample that shit, though. And so sent it over to Kanye and shit, though, after that. And then they did all their stuff to it, though. And like I said, the way I had made it, though, I made it so I can put my tag in it and shit. This time, though, I was like, okay, I know what to do now. This is the third time around now, you know what I'm saying? So, boom, fast forward now. I never heard the song, but it was about a song about to come out. Boom, I hear it now. And so the song started with 2 Chainz saying, yeah, birthday, it's your birthday. Ain't no Sonny Digital tag nowhere.
Yeah.
I'm like, hold on, what's going on, man? I hit him, I'm like, man, what's going on, bro? Y'all can't, well, they said, man, they told me, like, the tag couldn't go there because, like, the way the song started and shit, though, with his vocals and shit, though, I was like, man. I'm like, I'm gonna just chunk it up because I know it's gonna be a good song. It's gonna do well. So
yeah.
And then that happened. That was the first, like, I just took so much shit with that song. So that was the first thing that happened with that song, though. And then the second thing, I was like, all right, I missed out on that, you know, my tag being on there. And then I was like, okay, cool. I'm gonna try this shit again. I'm gonna go to fucking New York where they shot the video at. We went to New York and shot the video in Yonkers, and paid for my own tickets, my own hotel rooms. We just did our own shit, just get up there and shit, though.
Yeah.
And if you look at the video, I'm in the video, but they cut my face off, bro, in, like, the fucking video, bro.
They really try to erase you from history on this one, huh?
Like, I feel like the industry has been trying to erase me since I got in it. Like, just really? Like you see like with the racks, that mistake, and then boom,
bro.
The next thing with the same damn time, these. And then the shit with the birthday song, and then I got then it's like, then the actual video, I actually go there, then, like, even the same shit happened the same damn time. I got cut out that video too.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it was like, I feel like the industry was, like, really just going against me, like, just trying to hold me down.
Do you think it's, like, intentional that there's, like, actually anybody out to get you?
I don't know, but like I said at the time, though, it just wasn't cool for, like,
the producer to be all
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, it wasn't cool, but I always stood my ground, though. You know what I'm saying? That's yeah. how I always stood around, though. And when niggas start doing that shit, though, like, after that birthday song shit, though, that was the last straw, though. You know what I'm saying? For me, though. And that's right. when I started working on my own projects and shit, though, and start Xing niggas out and start becoming I started leading my own projects and shit, though. You know what I'm saying? Because I was like, those situations, I'm like, man, those are situations I just had total, like, no control of. I did everything I possibly could, though. Right. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. I did everything that I could, though. And right. I still, like, I did everything right. And I'm like, another thing that pissed me off, I'm like, man, like, if you look at the video, it's so many other people in the video that ain't got shit to do with the song.
Right.
Who faces full-blown right. Sean. I'm like, man, listen.
You look cool, too. You got headband. You're man, all tall, skinny, this, the nah, hair sticking
this,
up.
This, what, nah, 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 nah. This is older Sonny. This is older Sonny. But older right, Sonny still look like, I mean, it wasn't nothing different. Like, I was yeah. like, it was like, it was still like, I was like, damn, like, everybody was in the video.
Yeah.
Except for me. I'm like, damn, I'm like, man, what the fuck going on and shit, though? So, that shit happened. And then, like, that shit really, it really, like, after that shit happened, that whole situation just really had me, like, feeling some type of way. You know what I'm saying? Like, I wasn't trying to, like, really like feel some type of way about the game, but that's just what it was, though. So I really started getting like real reclusive too, and I started doing my own thing, you know what I'm saying, because that's what I was comfortable with doing, because I can control those situations,
right.
You know what I'm saying? So and so since I can control those situations, that I start fucking with my own artists and shit, though, you know what I'm saying? And I start messing with my boy Q.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we had started doing all the stuff, and like me, and that's my bro and shit, though. Yeah. So we went to school and everything together, though, and like shit's so crazy. Like, man, it's so crazy. Like, I start doing all my own shit. Like, I start fucking with like all my own people on my own, like my boy Tracy T, and it's like literally everybody I was fucking with, though, too. Everybody got deals and shit, though, and yeah. everybody it was like all easy situation that I had like a little say so in, though, too. So
right.
that's what started working for me, though. But I started doing that shit, like, I started fucking with Q, and that shit started working, and then Q had brought the Migos over to me a long time ago, like, a lot of people don't know that, too, like, Migos, you know, we all from, like, none of the same side of town and shit, though,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying, so, like, they knew each other, Q brought them to me, like, they knew each other, and I knew Kiari, like, more than Quavo and Takeoff, so... And I think Q and Takeoff, they used to play basketball and shit together, whatever. Something uh-huh. they used to hoop or something. Everybody from the same side of town, though, so it was like, it wasn't like everybody was too disconnected from each other.
But you look at somebody like Migos and you're like, damn, I wish I had like stayed more on top of being part of their career.
Nah, it was like a little falling out that happened, though. But I mean, everything was still cool. Like right now we still cool and everything. Like, it ain't no beef or nothing. Like, it was like just like a little early on, like it was like the shit that I had already seen that was going on in the game, but it was going on amongst like my people and shit, though, like early on, though, because shit was starting to happen and shit, though.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, shit was starting to go on, though, and like when shit go on, like other shit happen. You know what I'm saying? It'd be shit that people don't understand. You know what I'm saying? But like I mean, we was always cool. Like everybody was always cool. Like they was all like, oh, like with me, I never was like always on some like trying to hold niggas down and shit, though. I was always just trying to like. And, like, how I do today, just, like, always trying to, like, tell niggas, like, right things to do, the wrong things to do. Like, you know right. what I'm saying? Like,
but the young dudes in Atlanta always mention you as being somebody that looks out for young up-and-coming dudes more so than, like, the actual artists and shit. Would you say that's true?
I mean, shit, they told you.
Yeah.
I'm not telling you, you know what I'm saying? I mean, but, like, yeah. you know, like, but it ain't nothing that I'm doing in looking for credit for it, though. It's just
right.
that I really just... Like I fuck with like all these up and comers, though. I fuck with that energy more than the people that's on, though. And
right.
like you understand, the people that's on, they already think they know everything, though. So I can't go into their session like trying to like tell them what I think they should do over certain things, because they already successful with the shit,
right.
though.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But somebody who ain't really got it yet, though, I can kind of help them out and give them an idea. Like I can put my creativity into them and like kind of help them out, though. You know what I'm saying?
Because like, you've seen crazy success, like with the birthday song, for instance. You could have easily like stayed in that lane of trying to just work with the biggest artist possible.
Yeah.
Do you feel like you get a lot more out of like going and working with Q, which is obviously it's way more of a risk on your end trying to like build a whole career,
bro? It's risky, but it's fun, though.
Yeah.
I mean, I really take the risk, man. Instead of like, cause I can't bank on. You know, I really take the risk with my friends, though. You know what I'm saying? And
right.
then like, and then after I started seeing how easy it was, I was like, man, this shit's too easy. Like,
right.
Like, really, like, it was, like, damn near everybody who we start fucking with, like, just
yeah.
started, like, popping off, like, right, like, everybody, like, it was so crazy, it's so crazy, like, it's, even, like, up to today, like, it's, like, everybody.
Right.
Everybody, like.
Give me some more examples of people you are instrumental in pushing to the forefront.
21
is the obvious one.
Hell yeah.
Hey, 1 foot in, 1 foot out.
Yeah,
that's the best beat.
Bro, I was telling, like, man, me and 21, like, we had did that whole tape. Bro, I was like, man, like the whole thing, I was like, bro, you need to shoot videos to all these songs, yeah, though. I was like, if you shoot video to all these songs, they'll go up, though. You see, I shot a video to that, and it was some other songs, too. But, like it was like I don't know, I fucked with him too, and like the way we just kept on bumping into each other was like just weird, like, right. Like it was like y'all need to work with each other type shit,
because he was mostly unknown before that that Savage tape that you did with him, right? Or not Savage, but the Free Goo Up tape.
I was like the first like producer like to come and link with him and shit though, like on that shit though, like I don't know. I just fuck with it, though. I was like, it was just something new. Then my boy Key had brought it over to me, though, right, too. Yeah, you know, yeah. Key my homie, too.
You're filling in for Key right now. Key was supposed to do the interview tonight.
I know. You know, it's my bro, so, you know, I'm going to come in and come scoop up for my boy. But, you know, he be all over the place, though. But, yeah, Key was, like, one of the main reasons why I had started fucking with 21, though, because I really fuck with Key, though. And, like, I had already been seeing 21 around, though. But it's more about, like, who I see you with and who I meet you with, though. Right. You know what I'm saying? And I finally had seen him with Key one day, and we was in New York or something like that. I forgot where we was at, though. But after that, we came back to the A. I started fucking with him, and we did that. We did the Red Ops and all that shit. And, you know, a lot of people don't even know this show, though. What you call it? He had me and him made that beat, bro.
Right.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like
so he was sitting in there with you?
No. Made the beat. Like, oh, really? Like, you know what I'm saying? We in there, like, he telling me what to do. He pressing the keys, you know what I'm saying? Like, really? I'm, like, fixing up shit. Like that's what we was doing with the whole little Free Goo-Wop mixtape. Like,
yeah,
that shit was, like, interesting. Like, you can go back on my IG page. Like, it was, like, really, like, a little, document, like, with, like, little shit, though. Like, we'll be in there, like, just recording. Like, he recorded himself. Like, he did everything himself. Like, I told him how to do it. He did everything himself, recorded. I just made the beats. Boom, he recorded. He recorded Red Ops himself, too. Like, I remember he was sitting right there, like, he did all that shit himself, like, and, like, I don't know, shit. It was just easy, you know what I'm saying? Like, that was just, like, fun. Like, it was just, like...
You were at all surprised seeing him explode? Or did you believe that was probably a possibility pretty early on?
Nah, bro, I just don't never miss when it come to that shit, bro. You know what I'm saying? I was kind of, like, I didn't really know how it was because it was, like, it was too gangster, but I was like, man, but this is kind of, like, I feel like this is what, like, niggas, like, kind of like, missing this shit,
like,
though.
Yeah, they want to hear that shit.
Man. You know what I'm saying? Like, they want to hear that shit, though, so it was, like... Shit, I'm about to sit here and just create this shit with him, and you know, like it was just fun though. Then on top of that too, it was like shit. He really like authentic, so it was like shit, I can really do this shit, and like you know what I'm saying, like and it can you know what I'm saying.
You feel like that's like an instrumental part of it taking off is the fact that the shit he was saying was kind of like shock value, like oh shit, this nigga talking about shooting kids at the fucking playground, but people believed it.
He didn't say he was gonna shoot him. He just said that they were getting shot.
But it was people believed it. All right, though,
so
too.
See, look, this is what it was, bro. Like anybody can say that shit though.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? But when he started putting them looks onto it though, and people start seeing how he looked, they were like, oh shit, maybe he did do this shit. You know what I'm saying? Like
this ain't
a nigga. Like, but.
His image and like his video style being so consistent and everything, like is that stuff that you put thought into? Is like how an artist is presented overall?
I mean, you got to you got to look at how you being presented all the time though, in my eyes though, you know what I'm saying? Like, I think that was another thing too, why it took so long for like a lot of them videos to come out though too, like because it wasn't going to be presented the 100% right way like we needed it to be, though. You know what I'm saying? The Red Ops was the best video, and you see how it did, you know what I'm saying? Like, that was the best video to me. Not that he did, though, but that came off that tape, though.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that was, like, the best one that came off the tape, and that one did, like, pretty good for one, though, because it was presented the right way, you know what I'm saying?
Like, so many people hit me up trying to get interviews, and they have never even done a video, and I'm like, man, that's like, step number one if you want to, like, if you care at all about how you're being presented.
Mm-hmm.
You know? Bye. Yeah. But yeah, like 21 to me is like such a good example of that, because his shit has always just been so consistently good at presenting him the way that he wants to be presented, you know?
Yeah, like that was one thing. I was like, me and him, he's like, we used to talk like a lot, like he'd be telling me all these stories and shit though. And like we'll be talking like about a lot of shit though. We'll just be talking, and like I'd be like, bro, this shit need to be like documented, bro. Like this shit need to be like put on like wax somewhere. I don't know, like, you know what I'm saying? Like somebody need to really see this shit though, you know what I'm saying? That's how I felt about this shit though, like. And then shit, but it, you know, that shit at the time, that shit cost money, and then like it wasn't like really no money being made at the time though. It was all kind of like we was just working though, you know what I'm saying? It was like Shit, we just all taking a shot though. You know what I'm saying? The money I was making though had to go back into what I was doing anyways, yeah. though. Like as far as like producing and shit though. And then you know what I'm saying, like shit.
That's what's up. At what point does Gucci in your career get in touch with you? And what does he say to you?
Well, I mean, he hit me when he got out of jail. Yeah.
Oh, okay. So you hadn't talked to him before he was out of jail?
Nah.
Didn't you do production for him before all that? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But you know, I'm in there, but I loosely play around the field. Like, I'm like loosely around. But everybody, they know me. They fuck with me, though. But they know how I move, though. Like,
that you're not around that much. You're not a super social creature.
I'm social, but I'm here, but I ain't here. You know, everybody know I'm doing my own thing, though, too, though. You know what I'm saying? Like,
but as a rap fan, when Gucci wants beats from you, are you not just like, oh, man, I got to go in the studio with him for a little bit and see what Gucci's like?
Nah, bro, Gucci, I can just send him some shit, man. Like, he sent me, like, he had hit me, and that's what he wanted. Then, shit, send him some beats, and that was that, though. But, I mean, Goo, it ain't hard to get in contact with him, though. So, like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
well, for you, maybe, for the average person, probably.
Nah, I mean, shit. He cool. He a cool nigga. Like, I don't press up on him. I don't be trying to go chill and shit, though. I do what I need to go do. And I hope niggas fuck with it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And that just be that, though. But, shit. Everybody cool to me. Everybody casual. He emailed me that, actually, bro.
Really?
DM me, then email me. We just talking through there. You know what I'm saying?
Email from Gucci, like, just straight up, like, yo, I need some beats.
Shit, regular email. I thought it was the engineer at first, though. Then I was typing on, like, yeah, he's WAP. Yeah, it's cool. No way, cool.
What's
though,
that? The 50 Cent song you have that's doing really well right now?
Oh, I'm the Man.
I'm the Man, yeah. Well, what's the story with that? Like, why is it on the charts now if it came out in 2015?
I be forgetting about all these songs.
I just seen that on your Instagram, and I was like, I did not know he worked with 50, and I didn't know that song was doing so good right now.
Yeah, well, you know, 50 Cent, you put that all together, that shit going on the show. Yeah. So, you know, That shit, that's off top though. So that's some different type of money though. But originally, that song, I had put that song out like by myself like a long time ago, not a long time ago, but probably like a year ago, 2 years ago now. Like, but it was like me by myself though, and it was like them like my first song like as me like as an artist.
Yeah.
And a song that I produced on though, but it was a good ass song though. Like, the beat was fire, the lyrics was fire, the hook was fire.
You save a lot of your best songs for yourself.
Nah, bro.
Not a lot, but here and there.
Nah, I just get creative with myself because that's when I got the most freedom though. Okay, you know what I'm saying? That's when I kind of do what I want to do.
Beat for yourself.
I can do everything, so I can really kind of showcase like where I can go with it though and shit though. You know what I'm saying? So that was that situation. So the song had been sitting up on my SoundCloud for like a year, and it had been doing well, and that's kind of what people kind of got reintroduced to Sonny like as an artist though, and where they kind of took it serious though.
Cause you hadn't been rapping for a while before that.
I had been rapping way before then though, but
break.
Yeah. Nah, I was the producing just overshadowed everything I was doing. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And then like when I started fucking with everybody, like doing artists like them, they're building niggas up situations and shit though. I got to the point where it was like, shit, let me start trying to do this shit for myself. I keep on doing it for everybody else. You know what I'm saying? Like.
Yeah.
I can do this shit too. You know what I'm saying? I already been doing it. Now I got the formula. Now
you
I got
do
the platform.
Sound natural on the mic. It's not like you're like kind of doing something weird by being the producer on the mic.
Bro, I've been doing this shit forever though. But see, then with that song too, with the I'm the Man song.
Yeah.
See,
but what, 50 sees it on your SoundCloud and is like, oh, I want to redo this?
You know, somebody my manager told me 50 had liked it like a couple months prior. But it just went over my head. Then he had came to Atlanta. Then
you're doing good that 50 Cent could like your song. You don't give a fuck.
Yeah. He just like, I forgot. This shit slipped my mind.
I was like, he ain't call me or nothing to tell me that shit. So I was like, shit, you know, man. Anybody. I was like, shit. It could be. I'm like, shit. It's a lot of people that like this song, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, shit, that's cool. It ain't doing nothing for me. Shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
that's real shit.
That was some real shit, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm trying to do my thing. But shit, you liking my song. You know what I'm saying? Shit, I appreciate it, but.
Yeah. That's shit, some real shit.
You a millionaire, bro. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to get where you at. Yeah. But, so shit. He came to Atlanta, and then when he came to Atlanta, he had called all the producers to the studio and shit. He called Tim, Zay, Cassius Clay, fucking London on Track.
Big meeting, everybody, all the power players.
Yeah, a lot of them. I think, I don't know if Sizzle was there. I think only people that wasn't there, I think Sizzle and Metro was probably out of town, though. I can't remember, though. But I know Metro for sure wasn't there, though. But But I think I'm pretty sure he was out of town though. I was like, I think that was the only person that wasn't there. I was like, dang man, this is like damn near like on some real like power call type shit though.
Yeah. But 50 Cent comes to town, calls all the producers there. It was like an X-Men
just crazy. So when he first walked in, this is when I knew. I was like, okay, this shit probably for real. He was singing the song.
Really?
Yeah, I was like, oh.
He walked to the door singing the shit?
Yeah, I was like, okay. I was like, this shit might be real. And shit. He was just fucking with me from that point on. He was fucking with me. Like, he was like, on some, like, I fuck with you as an artist and shit, though. You know what I'm saying? I was like, okay, cool. Now he's solidifying me that I'm actually good as an artist and shit, though. Like, okay, cool. So, boom, boom. So, we that night, I had gave him some old beats and shit, though. So they had hit me back and they was like, man, look, we want to do that I'm the Man song and shit, though.
Yeah.
I was like, okay, cool. So basically, I had he kept me on the hook. You know what I'm saying? Kept me on the hook and then basically just redid the verses and shit, though. And just plugged in and just did the middle thing, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. That was it, though. And that song just, you know, it was going to do it. It's 50 Cent, though.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And it's a good song too. You know what I'm saying? So, you know what I'm saying? It was just good though. But
it's nice doing a song for somebody who has the power to just put it on TV like a million times.
Yeah, like when that happened too, I can notice the change. Like that, I can notice the change too. Like as an artist too, though.
The change in like the amount of shit coming to you online or?
Nah, like as far as like, cause you know it was weird. It's weird times for me though too, though, because a lot of people know me but they don't know what I do.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like
weird for a producer.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So it's like it was kinda weird but it was kinda fun though too because it's like at that time now a lot of people might just know Sonny as the artist.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And that's good for me though. Then like so when they find out I produce too, I find out everything else that I do is gonna be like, oh shit, this nigga cold.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Cause a lot of people just now finding out about Sonny Digital, a lot of people just not finding out about all this shit.
A lot of people aren't capable of like understanding who a producer is. I feel like
they're not though. Because when I started to really unfold this shit, I was like, damn, bro, this shit would blow somebody's mind away. Yeah, like exactly. how much work one person would really do. You know what I'm saying? Like you know what I'm saying? Like
everybody has this like outside perception of music, and they look at a fucking a well-oiled machine, as you would say, or like you know somebody with a whole team of people behind them. They just see that one person and think like, you know. Yeah, but they don't really know what the fuck's going on in the background.
Yeah, it's a lot more than that, bro.
We got to talk about Tuesday.
Oh yeah,
and what that was like when that blew up, and you'd been messing with McConan for a little bit before that happened, or that was the first song you made with him, though, right? Or
I don't sell. I don't sell. Molly was the first song that I made with McConan. That's the first song that we made and shit.
Would you call that your biggest hit?
I don't sell Molly or Tuesday.
Or do you say that about Birthday Song?
Well. Well, I think numbers wise, I think probably a Birthday Song is probably bigger than
you had complete control basically over the beat with the Tuesday, right?
Kinda. You know, me and Metro made that beat.
Oh, okay.
Me, Metro, and McConan actually made that beat. Oh, okay. You know what I'm saying? It was all three of us on that beat.
So
though.
You don't mind having the artists like in there like messing with the production while you're working on it?
I'm an artist too.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I respect your space. If you know how to make beats, shit, what I'll be mad at you for?
Right.
Shit, get on these keys, bro. We're gonna make this shit real simple, man.
But McConan have been bubbling for a while, and then you just kind of dip your toe in, and boom, it just explodes out of the water.
He wasn't bubbling, bro.
He wasn't?
Nah, what had happened was shit. That shit was the weirdest situation, too. Like, man, like, on some weird shit, like, me and Metro, we used to be on this website, I Love Poundage and shit, though. Uh-huh. You'd be these girls shaking their ass and shit. We used to click on the videos and shit. And McConan's songs would be playing in the background and shit, though.
Right,
and they'll have his shit in the description. And then me and Metro look him up. And we seen him by this... By this sign in Atlanta that say Mechanicsville. That's when we found out he was in Atlanta and shit though. But this is like we didn't really go looking for him and shit though. So what had happened was Metro happened to be at I think DTPR or something like that one day, and then Mike Will was the one who really found McConan, like found him like as a person and shit though. So and Mike Will had him up there working with I guess 2-9 and shit though, and then he had seen Metro up there too. And then that's how they linked up and shit, though. He went to Metro House from there, though. And then Metro, you know, he had knew that we had been looking him up and shit, though. And Metro had just called me one day. I'm like, hey, pull up to the crib, bro. And Metro literally stayed, like, walking distance from me, though. So I walked over to the crib and shit, though. And then walked over to the crib, and then I seen McConan in there, and I'm like, hey, what's happening? I'm a fan, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. And he doing the same shit to me, like, hey, I'm a fan, bro. I'm like, shit, after that, we just got to work and shit, though. We got busy, motherfucking. Matter of fact, I think we, damn, did we do Tuesday that night? I think we did do Tuesday that night, bro.
Yeah, yeah. And then
we did do Tuesday that night. Then
Molly the next day.
Yeah, then the following day, we, because he was tripping on fucking, shrooms that night. He was on shrooms and shit.
When he first came out, like in interviews and stuff, he'd be talking about shrooms, doing shrooms on camera.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I like
that
about him.
Yeah, he still be doing this thing, man. But like he was on that shit, and we had did the whole mixtape that night.
Yeah,
we did the whole thing that night, and then like he had went over. He had told Spins about him, DJ Spins, and we had took him over to Darp and shit, though, and he started doing a couple tracks with Spins, though, and that's how we did that first mixtape. I think that's Drink More Water and shit, though. That's how all that shit came about, and all them songs on there. So all the songs we had did during that time was like, that's what like made his, nah, I ain't gonna say made his career, but like that's what like kind of like, yeah, cause I ain't gonna discredit anything he had going on. Like he was on the right track, though.
But he's still totally an underground artist at the time. Yeah,
yeah, like, and, cause like all the tracks that he was on too, though, they was all co-produced by him damn near. You know what I'm saying? Cause he'd come in, play the keys, and have all the songs ready, though. Cause I Don't Sell Molly, Tuesday, all them songs were already recorded. They was old. You know what I'm saying? All them songs, so everything was coming in, was he was one taking everything and shit, though. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? He was one taking them shits, and like, but he was one taking everything revamped. So everything is like Tuesday 2.0,
right? Yeah.
Fucking I Don't Sell Molly 2.0 with the bass drums and shit. Everything like how he dreamed of having this shit. Uh-huh. This how it was going now. You know what I'm saying? So, boom, that was that, though. But then after that, so we put out the tape with all the songs on it, motherfucking Tuesday and I Don't Sell Molly on there. I'm like, I Don't Sell Molly is about to be a banger, bro. I'm like, that's why I'm like, that's it right there. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, I'm behind that 100. And then, motherfucking, that shit going up is doing numbers. The video come out is doing numbers and shit, though. But this is a song about drugs.
So, it's so a you always have faith in that?
No.
Oh.
It was a ceiling on it.
Yeah,
I knew it.
Hold it back, yeah.
I was like,
yeah,
it's a ceiling on this song. I was like, damn, this song going to do well in the streets. It's going to get his career started, though, with... You know what I'm saying? The shit was so weird too. I was like, I don't know how to make this shit translate to people, like, to where they can understand, like, this shit gonna like work.
Most
though.
People haven't sold Molly, so it's not like the most relatable song.
Yeah, it wasn't, but it was just a groovy song though. Like when, bro, I'm not gonna lie, like that song go dumber than any song that I play on my set, bro. Like when I play I Don't Sell Molly, you can turn that shit down. All you gonna hear them white kids, I don't sell Molly no more. Had that shit rocking and play it back again. They gonna do it again, bro. Like that's like the highlight of my night every time. I ain't gonna lie. Like I feel proud about making that song though. Like, but
was that accurate for the time period in McConan's life that he had like recently stopped selling drugs, you think?
You know what? His life is crazy, bro.
I heard that there's a lot of stuff.
Crazy, bro. Like it started getting too crazy. I was like, you know what? I don't want to know too much about this shit. Like
let me fall back a little bit.
Yeah, like, so if you were selling drugs, I don't know. You probably was. I don't know. But,
hey, pass me bro.
You know, when we met McConan, he was still on house arrest.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
But we didn't even know that, though. He would just be leaving early, though, too.
Really?
Yeah, he'd be leaving early. Like, I got to go. You know what I'm saying? And so... I don't know, but that shit crazy though. But we did then motherfucking with Tuesday. Mm-hmm.
Oh,
go ahead,
yeah.
Oh no, I had some other shit to ask you about, but go ahead.
Tuesday, we gotta keep going for how this explosion felt and what happened. Yeah.
All right, so Tuesday, we just sitting on SoundCloud and shit though. It wasn't racking up plays. It was just like song number two.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? That's what it was. You know what I'm saying? And then
did you think that this had the potential to be huge?
No.
It didn't really hit you. Okay.
But I'm going to give it to my partner, Flea, though. Uh-huh. My partner, his name, Flea. He was in Atlanta. He was sitting on the couch and shit, though. He was really bobbing to this shit. Like, boy, this shit a banger. I was like, it's cool.
He's like, all right.
It's cool because the song was simple. Like, we did the song like this. Like, literally, like.
Right.
Damn near, like, three sounds in that motherfucker. Like, one take, three sounds, boom, next song. Went none more to that shit. So, motherfucking, after that. We did that, and then we put the song and put the mixtape out, and shit, it was just sitting up there. And then one day, I'm just working. We back working, and then I get a call from a New York number, and I always kind of figure New York numbers, they're important and shit, though, right?
Probably a scammer.
Probably a scammer. I don't know. Probably a scammer. So I didn't pick up the line. I texted him back. I was like, who this? He texted back. Like, Drake. Like scammer.
Some scammer.
Like, nigga. All right.
Something fishy is going on here. Yeah, right. All right. So.
How long did it take for you to believe that it was actually Drake?
I called the number back, and I can like pick the voice. I was like, okay, it was him. And I had met Drake a couple times before though. You know what I'm saying? I met him before though, and so I just didn't have his number though. You know what I'm saying? And
tough number to get, probably.
Man, everybody's easy to get in contact with when they need something from you though, bro. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So it's easy to really get in contact.
Well, you got all these number one hits. Yeah, it can't be that hard for you.
Number one hits, man. They just know I got beats, man. I got to provide these motherfuckers. But
right.
Yeah. Matter of fact, Drake had followed me first on Twitter, though. I didn't even know he followed me until somebody had, like, text me on some, like, Drake followed
That's
me.
Just depressing when you get to the point where you can't really, like, you have, like, important people following you and you don't notice.
Man.
And you're like, God damn, I missed that one.
Yeah. I was like, yeah, bro. They got this little side on a new little Twitter app that lets you see all the verified people. So
well, because you're verified, yeah.
Y'all ain't got that. No, everybody got that.
They won't give it to me because I got to swear on my name.
You got to be verified.
What?
You got to be verified to have that verified column.
Yeah.
Oh, damn. I thought everybody had that shit.
We're going to get there sooner or later.
Yeah, we on the way.
Nah, bro.
You exclusive gang, bro.
Nah, man. That shit. Work hard for them blue checks, man.
Hey.
I made it so everybody else can get the blue checks, man.
I feel it, bro.
You want to know what?
I got a check on my shorts right now, but that's it.
The first day I got the first.
Oh, we good.
Got the verified joints.
Oh, that's hard, though.
Our homeboy made this. Yeah. We can get you those if you want. Yeah,
let me get some of those. Bro. Yo.
Shout out, Roseman.
The day I got verified, I had met Dr. Dre the same day.
Damn, really?
Bro. Yeah, I was drunk as fuck, too, bro.
Where were you?
He's
been verified since before Twitter.
Yeah, that was verified real life, dude, right there.
I got that day was crazy. That whole day was crazy, though. But all right, back to the Tuesday song. So Drake had called. I had called and he had picked up and then we was talking and he was like asked me if you could get on the Tuesday song, and in my head I'm like, hell yeah, like shit, come on, bro. Yeah. Shit, send the verse over. I'm ready right
asking
now.
You.
That's what I was like. Shit. I was like, well, yeah, right. Like, why you asking me then? He was then he started asking me to ask McCone if it was cool. So I called McCone, like, bro, this nigga Drake trying to get on the song. And like, he like, shit, fuck it, let him, like, Drake. I mean, he was like, okay, let's do it, you know what I'm saying? And then I had called Metro. And I called Metro, and Metro didn't pick up the first time. He had called me back. Then we was sitting there talking, and then he was like, he had told me something. I ain't gonna say it though. He was like, somebody else had done something to it. Like he was like, somebody else was gonna get on it. I like, bro, we need to make this move, bro. Like this, I think this one gonna be the one right here though.
Right.
And that one was shit. That song came out, and then shit, that Drake effect happened and shit. You know what I'm saying? That shit shot to goddamn, like, number one and shit, though. And, like, that,
Did you get, like, nominated for a Grammy or
something?
Yeah,
shit?
Both got it. It did. It did, as a matter of fact. It did. Like, it was pretty cool. Like, that Drake effect, it ain't no joke. Yeah. That shit take you to another level, though. Like, and then that was my first actual, like, platinum, like, song, like, within, like, a time frame of it coming out to where, like, up until now, like, it went platinum. Like, it didn't take long for it to, like, go platinum and shit, though. So,
right.
Like, that was that. And
are those the life-changing checks that you get off of that kind of situation, or is it just all right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's crazy.
I mean, I don't know what life-changing checks is, though. I mean, like, a couple million is life-changing to me, though. A couple hundred thousand, you can run through that. You can spend that. You can buy a house, bro. You can count that. You know what I'm saying? If you can
Especially
count that.
In Atlanta, you can buy a house.
Yeah, right. Yeah, bro. You know what I'm saying? You can count that. If you can count where you can spend that money, yeah, it ain't enough, man. You know what I'm saying?
You just mentioned Dr. Dre. I was going to ask earlier. I'm like, is there anybody, like, who makes you starstruck? Who blows your fucking mind being around him? Because, you know, you're in Atlanta. You're around Gucci and Jeezy and all these motherfuckers who are OGs. You've been around them. Who is it that would really just blow your mind?
I don't know. I think it wouldn't be no rapper, though. No rapper. It would have to be, like, a female singer or some shit that, though. Like something like a new magnitude of this shit, though. Because rappers damn near, like, all the same, though. Like,
bunch of dudes hanging out.
Yeah, yeah. And get the blunt passed around. We all going to get to talking about the same shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, you just like me? Oh, shit. Like, we regular like shit. Like, all right, cool. So, yeah. I think it's going to probably, I don't know, like, it had to be, like, somebody who I probably never thought I see myself with like on some Adele shit or some shit. Adele. Or, I don't know. Like on some, I don't know. Like,
well, if I saw a selfie with you and Adele, I'd be pretty taken aback too. That would be pretty fire.
Don't be surprised, bro. I bumped in for real. I ain't never think I was gonna bump into him.
Yeah, I seen that photo. Yeah.
I bumped into him, and you know it was crazy. He actually, when I bumped into him, I actually went up to him. This is the only nigga I went up to.
Okay.
Yeah. And then when I went up to him, I was like, we was talking for a quick second. I didn't think he knew me and shit though. You know what I'm saying? Like this shit be like weird. Like I don't be thinking these niggas be knowing me. Then we got to talk, and he's like, yeah, Pusha T was telling me all about y'all. Like,
really?
I like for real. I like dang. Like okay. I like shit. Niggas be talking and shit though. Like yeah. I was like okay. That's for tight, real. Bro. For real. No nigga.
Because you wonder with Pharrell, you're like, are you so famous and rich that you don't even know what the fuck is going
on?
Like,
yeah. Like that you don't know anything that's going on. But shit, I was like when he kicked it to me that he knew what was going on. Nigga. Then like situations like that too solidify me. Like let me just keep on doing what I'm doing. They ain't necessarily got to say nothing to me though. As long as I know they see me, then I'm good. As long as I know it's reaching that far though, they ain't.
That's real shit.
I'm good. You know what I'm saying?
But do you look at somebody like Pharrell and you're like, man, you're like recognized as a fucking icon, a legend who changed the whole game, and a lot of it is because of your production. Does that make you feel like, damn, I could reach another level of me?
Hell yeah, bro. I'm telling you, like, damn, like that's what put my career for me into perspective though. Like as to where I'm at and where they
right,
at though.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like
you feel like the shit all the time, but then you look at Pharrell and you're like, damn, them, that's a whole different thing.
Yeah, you feeling like I'm feeling like I got a catalog of hits and shit right, though. Yeah. Then Pharrell get to run through his shit 2 hours long and shit like damn, I forgot he did. Oh shit, he did. Oh shit, oh you be like, damn, this nigga all over the place. Like
nigga pulling
forgot that this nigga know how to sing, dance, motherfucking been on song with Daft Punk and all type of shit though. But
every motherfucker he brought in the game.
Exactly. Crazy, you know what I'm saying? Then you gotta look at the time span though too that it took though. Like it right. really like this whole career thing, like this whole rap game and the shit that we in though. Like the same amount of time it'll take for a regular job for you to be like a professional in that shit though, or really like maximizing that shit though. It's like the same thing with the music industry though. Like Pharrell started young as fuck though, but his career didn't really like hit the maximum level until now.
You remember Super Thug, 1999 with Nori?
Nah.
No. What? Well, like, but when I think of him,
I was eight.
Yeah, exactly.
I was eight.
But
was young.
2002, he produced most of Clips's first album, Lord Willing. And you got to think about
all
that.
All of Lord Willing.
Did he do the whole thing? Yeah, but like, I mean, that's like almost 20 years right
you
now.
You talking about, for real.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
that's
now,
crazy.
Now,
20
now,
years.
And niggas remember that. Like, and like, then it's like, too, when you do something timeless like that.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, when he did something timeless, though, so that's frozen time, though. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? They ain't going to get old. You know what I'm saying?
But you've had those moments many times. Like, you had that moment where every single person in the country was singing Tuesday, and you could have been in any bar or club in America, and you could be standing there like,
but we ain't going to know.
We did this.
We ain't going to know that until 10 or 15 years from now, though. Yeah. We ain't going to know how big certain things are, though, until later on, though. Like I said, though, when I look at, like, niggas like Pharrell and, like, Kanye, I understand where they at though and why they are where they at though. Like that's time. You know what I'm saying? Like you gonna have to put in that time though. Like even like let's say I'm not taking away from like Lil Yachty and stuff though. Lil Yachty can really be like hot as fuck though. You know what I'm saying right now though, but it's still like his time invested doesn't equal to the same amount of time invested like as a Kanye West star, like for real though. So it's like they can stop today, you know what I'm saying, and they can still be here. You know what I'm saying? Like he could stop today and be forgot about the next year and stuff, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, on some, like because, you know, it's like, different time investment. Same with me, though. Like, I can, I feel like I don't have enough time invested, like, to stop at all. Like I can stop today and, like, niggas will forget about the catalog that I did. Like, I got to keep working.
But if you do another 10 years, then you might get to that. But do you feel like you're still kind of out for your respect? Is that what drives you partially, or is it just?
Yeah, I mean, I guess that's the fun part for me right now, like just going capturing my respect for the shit though, or for what I'm doing though, and then like too, like I said, it's weird for me though too though, cause certain people know I'm producing, some people think I'm a DJ, some people think I don't know, and some people think I'm an artist. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just fun trying to get everybody on the same accord though too. You know what I'm saying? Even though it's kind of frustrating, it's still kind of fun though. You know what I'm saying? Like. In my eyes, though, like it's cool. Like,
well, what makes you with a certain song like 50 on My Wrist, which has been a pretty big hit on its own, like doing crazy SoundCloud numbers and shit? What makes you like, oh, I'm gonna make this my song instead of going and passing this to somebody else and having them put verses on it?
Well, it don't never start like that though. But the beat, I always treat the beats like it's for anybody though. Like I remember I played that beat for like a lot of people though. Particularly, I remember playing it for Nipsey Hussle.
Oh, okay.
I played that for Nipsey. I was like, damn, I think he'll go hard on this motherfucker, though. But he didn't use it and shit, though. And I had a hook in my head, though. I don't know if it was the 50 on my wrist hook, though. But I had something in my head, though. And I went back to Atlanta, too. And I went back to Atlanta, and I think I did this in March or whatever, though. Probably earlier, though. But I went back, and I had just recorded this shit, though. I'm like, damn, this shit actually sound, like, decent and shit, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, right. The idea was actually flowing out of my head, like, I think they should, though. And, shit, that was that, though. And I had already done prior songs, though, but when the shit started actually, like, when I started to actually, like, learn how to use my voice and stuff, like, that's when shit started coming out the right way and shit started sounding good and started, like, giving me confidence. And on top of that, too, that I'm the Man song just kind of, like, helped out, like,
right,
me feeling, like, confidence being an artist, like, you know what I'm saying? Because it was, like, people like me as an artist, whether they like it or not, though, you know what I'm saying? Because just really because of that song, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, because a lot of people don't even know I was on the song, though.
Right.
So I was like, I know people subconsciously like me as an artist, though. They just don't like how I'm doing it, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? They just don't like, I mean, I ain't gonna say they don't like how I'm doing it, though. Or they don't really understand this shit right now, though.
Right.
It's coming from the opposite way. Like, producer coming the opposite way on you. You know what I'm saying? Usually rap producer or, like, producer being a producer or rap being a rapper.
But don't you feel like you're kind of at the, one of the, not, like, the only one, but, like, there's not that many, like, producers out now who can go and do like a DJ set in LA at a ham party or at a big thing. Like, I feel like you were kind of one of the first dudes through the door in terms of being able to be a producer, but actually tour and play like big venues, play a festival, do that kind of stuff. You noticed that you sort of broke down a wall in that regard?
Yeah, I feel like me and Metro and all of us, we all did that together, though. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, that was like a collective thing, though, because I'm gonna break it down like this. This is how I seen it in my eyes, though. How I seen it in my eyes and how we got to these positions too is because, like I said, at some point, like, it started becoming being cool, being a producer and shit, though. And, like, the artists that we was producing for was so big, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying, that, like, sometimes they couldn't, like, book the artists that we was producing for, though. You know what I'm saying? They couldn't afford it, though. And then some of the artists, like, the prices just wasn't right for them, though. So it's like they can't take them prices, though. So somebody got to come take that shit, though. You know what I'm saying? Somebody got to swoop in.
Somebody got to play all these Future songs when he's in Antarctica.
Yeah, you got somebody got to eat off this shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I feel like that's what we swooped in at, though. In my eyes, that's what I was looking at. Like, I was like, I know it's like certain bags that they can't get, though, that we can get, though. And, like, a lot of times they'll be banking on us bringing them people out, though, too.
Right.
Because a lot of times, though, like, those still the homies and shit, though. You know what I'm saying? So if we doing something, shit, they might want to just
pop up.
Yeah, just pop up.
Right.
On the love, you know what I'm saying? Like, you never know, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, and like the people who putting up the money, they win a little more like that too, and it's a little more safer though, you know what I'm saying? So.
But you love like being, you say you love being in the house, you don't like to be fucking with too many people like that. Like, is it then hard for you to be like, all right, I'm going to go on tour for 2 weeks?
Nah, because I like doing that though, okay. You know what I'm saying? When I say like, I'm a real interactive person and shit, though. I can fuck with people and shit, though. But it's like, you know, like actually fucking with people and shit, though. That's a different level and shit, though. Like getting to know people and shit, though.
Right.
All the extra stuff, like, man, I ain't really got the time for that shit, though, right now, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, now I don't know, like, disrespect shit, though. Like, shit.
But are you not, like, productive at all music-wise when you're on tour for 2 weeks?
It's hard to work on the road, bro. I ain't even gonna lie to you, though. Like, I gotta be kind of, like, I'm wake up, go to sleep here, be sitting here for a minute type of shit, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, I got to be here. You know what I'm saying? Like,
you wake up, you get like a half hour in the morning to try to get some work done, and it's like answering emails and shit. You don't really get in the space to be creative, right?
Basically, you know what I'm saying? Like, but
you know that we're ignoring possibly his biggest artist that he's worked with. Actually, definitely the biggest artist that he's worked with.
Who?
The queen of hip hop, Beyonce.
Oh, yeah.
Or wait, queen of R&B soul. What do they call her? No, they call Mary J. Blige that. You see Mary J. Blige had a death rumor on fucking Twitter the other day?
Yo, y'all seen that video with Mary J. Blige and Hillary Clinton,
but
bro?
What is she saying? I saw it, but I didn't click
it. I don't know. But that shit had me in tears.
I gotta watch that. I seen it, but I didn't click it.
Yo, that shit, she was saying some weird shit, bro.
Yeah, bro.
Against Hillary?
Nah, like, it was, like, some weird shit. Like, yeah, also, like, she was trying to express, like, what was going on in America, but, like, also, like, she should have somebody write that shit for her.
Yeah, she was saying some wild shit.
You pay attention to politics?
I do on the slick.
You
man.
Do?
I pay attention to everything. I be on everything, though. It's just, you know, I just keep to myself, though.
Now is a time period where everybody's paying attention to politics because everybody's genuinely scared the shitless that fucking Donald Trump might be the president.
Yeah, man. I went to D.C. and I was talking about this shit. I was telling them, like, talking for the millennials and shit, or millennials or whatever they call us and shit, or the young people and shit. I was telling them, I was like, man, a lot of people really just feel like they're back against the wall, though, because a lot of people don't, they're not really feeling Hillary, or they're not feeling like Donald. And this shit just like a gimmick right now, though. I was telling them, like, let's just logically make sense of this, though. Like, all right, how old do you got to be to vote, bro?
18.
I'm 25, bro. I've only been able to vote twice in my life, though, so I'm not even lathered or in the thing of being used to voting and shit, though. You know what I'm saying? So the only time I was able to vote was that time for Obama and shit, though. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? When shit was right, though, or when shit seemed like it was right, though, I seen it was going cool and shit, though, in my eyes and shit, though. But now my back against the wall with these two goofballs and stuff in my eyes, though. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, and they trying to, like, press people to, like, vote for either or. It's like, man, it's a lose-lose situation. You can't really win this situation, though. And, like, that's really, I feel like that's how, like, a lot of young people feeling, though. Like,
historically, like Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton are two of the most unpopular candidates of all time. I think the most unpopular candidates of, like, the past 30 years. Like, if you were to compare how popular Obama was to how unpopular Donald Trump is, like, he would be destroying her if he was able to run right now.
Yeah.
And it's crazy, but
so we got this
right now. Where it's at, though, shit, America probably needs some gimmick looking ass shit like this, though, man. Cause, like, I don't know, man. Like, I don't know, man. This shit just weird, though. Like, it's like this the only way that people gonna, like, really pay attention to this shit, though. Just like, if it was somebody else, we wouldn't be talking about it. But it's Donald Trump, bro. Right. I already told people, like, even though Donald Trump lose, he already won, bro. He a businessman ahead of everything, though. Yeah. Like, I see what he doing.
He already won.
That's what I said, bro. He gonna be like, how I almost became president and how you can too.
Bro.
TV show, boom. Somebody gonna give him that shit, bro.
Yeah, because he's got an army behind him of racist white people that are gonna watch that shit.
I don't know why people take him so serious, for to be honest. Like,
yeah, they like try to pull
like,
his.
Literally, bro, he is funny, bro. Every time I see him, I was watching shit last night, I was like, bro.
That's the problem. He's funny. They can't stop writing about him.
This nigga was saying facts.
wrong.
What's the face he was making?
He be snapping, bro.
He's never seen anybody interrupt that much in a presidential debate.
Bro,
ever.
He was funny. It's like, you said that Hillary Clinton looked like she was unfit for the position. What exactly did you mean?
He was like, look at her.
Calls out Rosie O'Donnell. Calls her like a fat piece of shit in the middle
bro,
of the thing.
Going
like,
crazy.
What is happening?
He's funny. He's really funny. Like, when I watch him, it's entertaining. Yeah. Like, he's an entertainer more than anything, though. Like, I don't see him as nothing else, though. Not the president at all, though.
If Donald Trump was a rapper, who would he be?
I'm not going to even put that on nobody,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah, because I don't even know where you going to go.
That's too bad, bro. Like, I'm not even going to put that.
Who's the biggest asshole rapper that's just got his head up his ass? I don't know. It would be bad.
Nah, though. He would be like a fucking, like a damn record label, like, nigga. Like,
yeah, like.
Oh, okay,
I'm trying to think. Whoa. Who. Oh.
Not no artist. He'll be on some record exec type shit, like Trump Records. That actually sound like a label too.
No,
like.
Easily Trump Records. Yeah. Perfect $1 million idea. You could be in there,
bro. And man, that nigga eating, bro. Like, them Trump Towers ain't going nowhere,
bro. Like you just said, that nigga won just by even getting this close, bro. Right.
I'm telling you,
nigga,
like,
took that shit as a joke this whole time, bro. The fact that he made it to the end.
That's what I'm saying. He made it to the very end, bro. Like.
I tweeted
he already
something
won,
like
bro.
A year ago, where I said, like, you know, you guys are all the fucking victims in this stupid joke because you're all taking Donald Trump seriously. This is never gonna happen. Yeah. Look at us now,
bro. I said that so many times. I'm like, y'all stupid if y'all think they really gonna let this nigga get that far, bro.
I didn't think they was gonna let it get that far though, but they had to do something to catch everybody's attention though. Cause I'm gonna let y'all know they ain't gonna let him win though. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna let Hillary win though. They're gonna be like, okay, maybe next year y'all motherfuckers don't pay attention. Like, it can't get bad out here. We can let these niggas get this close to this shit, though.
Yeah,
like,
man.
This is why they trick to get the young people to want to vote, or like,
right,
our people to want to vote, because we don't get to vote for another, like, what?
Four years after this. It's only 2 months away, isn't it? November.
Yeah.
It's like this shit been going on forever though, yeah, bro. It's like I feel like they like extended Trump this shit or something. Like
it felt like the election was around the corner like a year ago.
Yeah, well, bro. Like, bro, I feel like Obama been packing up, leaving out the office like for the whole fucking year.
Well,
bro,
he got reelected. So my nigga been in there for 8 years, bro.
Oh yeah.
He been in there damn near like my whole time. Yeah, you know,
almost
like
a decade,
nigga,
yeah.
Nigga, I was in middle school, in high school when he first got elected. Bro.
Yeah, that shit was lit though. I remember that. Yeah, though. But like I said though, niggas not even really used to voting though, bro.
Yeah.
Period
yeah.
though. That's the main thing though. I was trying to preach to them like, y'all trying to make us vote for these people that we don't like. Neither one of them and shit don't. We not even used to doing this shit though, and we got it like it's so much extra shit that's coming when you register to vote though. Like you get like that jury duty shit that I was hearing about. I'm like, man, I'm really not trying to do that though. Like,
I never answered one of those letters. I've been getting them all.
I don't want nothing like pertaining that coming to me. Like, I don't like no.
Being part of the system at all?
Not at all, bro. Not even on like, cause I don't want to be the person dictating what happens to somebody's life and shit though. You know what I'm saying? I ain't nobody God, bro.
Hey, I got a question. What's the stupidest shit you ever did with some money? Because I know you've had some moments in your life where you are really rich.
Shit, I done a lot of stupid shit, bro. I feel like spending money in the strip club always stupid when you come back home and you be like, fuck.
You still do that? Like in Atlanta, like you just hit the strip club and just go crazy or what?
I never went like ridiculously crazy in a strip club.
Like
I probably
ruin your whole life crazy.
Hell nah, never that. I can't even like. I only go to a strip club late at night. I go to when all the banks are closed.
Okay.
And so the max I can get out my account is like $500.
$500, yeah.
So you know it can't go over that. So you know what I'm saying. Right. So I just make sure I just stay at that limit though. But if I go earlier though, like if I go earlier, like I went earlier and went to the bank and got money out. The most I done probably threw in a strip club probably was like. 1,001 times though,
yeah,
but it was like
manageable. It's not the end of the world.
Yeah, it's manageable, and it was pre-planned too. It was like, I'm gonna go do this, so you know, this is what I got this for, and this is that, so I don't feel as bad though. But
if
like,
if you told me you threw $15,000 in a weekend or something, I'd be like, damn, you got a problem. You know?
Even if I had the money, bro, I'd be like, bro, this is just too much money to be wasting.
Yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah.
I ain't about to be spending this on these bitches, like.
But yeah. You feel like the man when you go in the strip club, like all the girls know you, and do you have to rely on them to play your song sometimes or what? Is that really how it works?
In the strip club, it just depends. Like it's like seasonal in the strip club in Atlanta and shit though. Like for real, like it's like a new little shift of girls in there now and shit though. So it's like some might know you, some might not though. You know what I'm saying? Like some might run up on you with that old ass game, like how you doing, like where you from? Like bitch, all these other bitches know where I'm from. You like go ask one of them hoes or something.
She don't
like,
know that you've been around too long for that game to work.
Yeah, like I'm like, man, you had like the strip club just opened up yesterday, like like the shit opened up when you walked in this motherfucker.
Is this you becoming an old grumpy old Atlanta man now though? Where you're not impressed by all the shit that you thought was cool when you were 19?
It probably is, man. I might be getting old in this bitch or some shit.
This is you becoming an OG where the strippers and their little small talk doesn't mean anything to you anymore.
If it is, bro, this shit move fast as hell. Man.
It do. You get jaded real fast.
Bro, nah. I'm 25 now, though. I ain't gonna lie, though. So shit has been moving fast, though. But
yeah.
But yeah, like, strip club's cool, though. Like, they show love, though. They definitely show love when you go in there. When I go in there now, too, so.
But yeah, the like, wrong kind of love, too, because you get every thirsty-ass rapper in your jock, huh?
Man, that's whatever, bro. I can go damn near anywhere in Atlanta.
Yeah.
I really like anywhere here, like where like I would probably be at on or just any like regular like just place. Like
yeah.
It's gonna happen. Somebody gonna be like, first they'll probably be like, Metro? I'm like, nah. Like,
you get that a lot?
Yeah. You know what's surprising, bro? This surprised the hell out of me. One time me and Metro was together, right? And somebody surprised they mistaked him for me. And me for him.
Right.
I'm like, bro, are you fucking serious, bro? Right. Like, we
niggas standing next to each other.
Producer like, problems right there, man. Yeah, is that right. they pay attention enough that they know your name, but they don't know exactly what you look like and shit.
Yeah, like, it's crazy, bro. That shit crazy as hell.
They're like, oh, you Sonny Digital? Like, oh, nigga.
Yeah, so, yeah, like, that's how people be finding shit. Yeah.
You talked a lot in that Hot 97 interview you did with Rosenberg and them about, like, how hard it is to fucking bail out on the conversations because you don't want to shit on somebody's dream and be like, no, I'm never gonna give you beats. Yeah. But at the same time, you want to try to be cool, but you can't ruin your whole life.
Shit, I'm at a point now to where this I handle them situations. So, say you are this man.
Well, let's just do a reenactment right now. I just asked you for some beats because I'm actually a rapper too. So,
let me
go ahead and just play this out. So
let's do it.
Yo, Sonny, bro, I really fuck with you, man. You know, no jumper, we doing this interview. So after the interview, let me get up on you with some beats, bro. Like, I send you my email right now, bro.
What you trying to do?
I need you to give me some beats for free because I'm a SoundCloud rapper and I need you to help me get my shit popping.
All right, I'm a rapper too.
Let's collab on a song.
Why?
Because you're tight and I could possibly be tight and possibly an asset to your entity.
Okay, no disrespect though, but I know I can add to what you're doing. What can you add to what I'm doing?
I might have a new sound or a new talent ready for you. Like,
but see,
like,
I'm gambling too much now, bro. Like, you might.
You struck gold on a lot of other people. You might be able to strike gold on me too.
Nah, I can't though, bro, because that's time. That's time invested though. You know what I'm saying? Like, all right, let me put it in this aspects, bro.
Yeah.
You a rapper, I'm a rapper, right?
Mm-hmm.
We after the same goal, right?
Yeah.
I'm trying to get bigger than you. I'm trying to stay bigger.
Well, you already bigger than most of the niggas who are gonna ask you beats like that anyway.
Yeah, you know, I'm trying to stay bigger than everybody though too. But I'm leaving room open though. Like, you can do whatever you want to though. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But I'm an artist too. So why would I give you some of my
materials?
Yeah, and you know what I'm saying? Yeah. To juice up your career. You know what I'm saying? Just honestly though.
No, that's
real shit. And I would be like, hey, bro, maybe you should probably just go learn how to make beats.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? And you know, then you get you an unlimited supply of beats. You do your thing. You ain't got to come ask me for beats though.
That's true.
Boom. Then if you do that though, look, now we got something to offer each other. You can offer me some beats that you making. I can offer you beats I'm making. Now we can collab. Now we bringing something to the table for each other.
Damn, that's fire.
You know what I'm saying? So now that's when it makes sense for me though. Like,
yeah,
anybody that I collab with that nobody knows stuff is like they are contributing to what I'm doing though. Like, they're either producing for me though. That a lot of people are producers and they rappers though.
Yeah,
just because they can give me something that I need too.
That's fine, bro.
You know what I'm saying? So it's kind of like, if it ain't gonna like add out like money wise, then like shit, let's really make it even though. Because I mean, shit, I can give you a beat and you can give me a verse though, but yo, we can really swap it out and make it all the way even, then shit. Let's do it that way.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's real shit.
I watched that interview with you and Rosenberg like 2 years ago and you were still on your you were still saying, oh, I got you.
Yeah.
You were like, I got you. You're like, I say that to people in the club every day. I got you.
Yeah, I mean, I still say that though, but like, it depends if I got the patience to like really like
it down.
Yeah, because that's really what it come down to. It's like, man, I'm a businessman, bro. Why would I give you my products when I can get rich off of them, bro?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Why would I gamble with you when I can gamble with myself and I know I'm going to win?
Exactly.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
That's real shit.
You feel bad, though, because you don't want to shit on anybody's dreams.
I ain't shitting on your dreams, though. I'm just keeping it a buck with you like shit. Like, honestly, like I said, shit. If you came to me and you had something to give me, like, if it was like a producer rapper and shit, though, or somebody that got beats for me and shit, though, shit, we'll swap it out. Mm-hmm. It's even. Nobody of nobody nothing. You know what I'm saying? And that's how you want it to be. You know what I'm saying? To keep it like that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, and just do it like that.
But if you just fucked with somebody just off there, like, this is like, you heard some shit, it's like, yo, this shit hard. Like, I'm going to hit this nigga up. I'm going to get this nigga a beat. I want him to rap on this beat. I feel like he'll sound tight on that beat. Like, you wouldn't do some shit like that?
Nah, because you open up a portal way and shit, though, now.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Now they going to want some more and shit, though. You know what I'm saying? You just kind of got to be patient, though. Certain shit, everything will make it to your doorway and shit, though. You know what I'm saying? When they need to and shit, though. So I don't never be rushing for this shit, though. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Then I don't want to be on the hype shit either, though. You know what I'm saying?
This has been an informative tutorial on how to shut down a SoundCloud rapper.
That was fine.
Nah, everybody can't do it though. But nah. I mean, shit, it's just, you know, then, you know, I got a little respect on my name though too. So you know, I really put in my own little work though. You know what I'm saying? To where I can do that shit though. You know what I'm saying? I didn't produce for everybody. You know what I'm saying? I didn't produce for a lot of unknown niggas. Like I was telling you, I was producing for like everybody before I got on though. So I did all my fair work though with everybody though. So
yo, can we talk about one of my favorite like collaborative efforts you've done? Mm-hmm. Fucking, when did you first link up with Juicy J and did like the rubber band business shit? And shit
geeked
like,
up man. Off them bars. We wouldn't, no, we would that, not be able to that. Say geeked up off them bars if it wasn't
before
around.
That. Before that,
man, how did I link up with Juicy J?
Did you do rubber band business one and two?
Or I think we was on both. I can't remember though.
You
were on those two?
Yeah, definitely two. I don't know if you're on number one.
I think number one probably was All X, probably.
I think it was All X, yeah.
And then number two, we did Rubber Band Business. Then after that was something else. I forgot which one that was.
Blue Dream and Lean?
Yeah, Blue Dream and Lean, yep. Mm-hmm. One and two. It was one and two. Bro.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, y'all niggas, y'all was going crazy.
Yeah, like that shit. You know what was crazy? A lot of them beats, like off that first one, them was older beats that I just had revamped and shit, though. I had revamped them and like put new sounds in them and shit though, and just turned up the bass and did that shit though, and sent them over to Juicy and shit though, and shit, those shits went dumb, bro. I was like, oh my god,
that revived his career, bro.
It did, bro. And like from that time though, that's when Juicy J, one of the realest niggas in the game too. Yeah. Let me put that on the table too. Like he ever since that point, he always fucked with me and shit though, but. Man, we was doing so much shit. Like, we was producing so much shit back then. A lot of people have forgot about that shit, though. Yeah. I that's before shit was popping and shit,
bro,
though. Like,
I fucked with that shit hard.
Bro, niggas man.
That shit.
Yo, that shit. That you remember that song, That Me?
Yeah, bro.
I grew up in the hood, so what? Bro, that shit. Oh, my gosh, bro. Like, sometimes when I be performing, I don't be playing that shit, though, because I don't be thinking a lot of people be knowing that shit, though.
This is niggas, but, niggas know. Niggas
yeah, but, like, some people, like, they'll be screaming that out in the crowd, like, play that Juicy J shit. I'm like, see, dang, like, yeah, I ain't no niggas went back that far on me, though.
That was an era, like, when he was full on making his comeback, and it was those exact tapes that you're talking about right there. That was the moment, like, for him. Like,
man, major moment, bro. Like, that was, like, man.
40-year-old men rapping about taking Xanax. That's what bro, I'm talking about.
Oh, my
right
gosh,
there.
Bro. Going crazy.
But really, nah, but really be doing that shit, though. But really be
I believe it.
Yo, really be going crazy, though. But then we did we had that shit going up, bro. I ain't gonna lie like that. That was fun times. And then we still work on a daily basis. Like, Juicy J, he was, like, a lot of times, too. Like, he'd be on, like, all the young shit, like, first before that shit popped. Like, a lot of times... Like, when Racks on Racks first popped off, too, that was, like, one of the first niggas that called me and was like, yo, let me get on this remix. I'm like, Juicy. Yeah. But I couldn't really, like, it wasn't my song, so, you know, I couldn't really dictate what was going on with that. I was just a part of it, though. You know what I'm saying?
He's done an amazing job over the years of staying on top of, like, what the kids are into and staying relevant. Do you feel like you sometimes are in that position where you're trying to stay on top of all the trends and what all these kids are into nowadays?
I ain't trying to stay on top of it, though. You more so like leading that shit.
Right, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
It's you're easy. Still leading it easily, yeah. You're it's definitely easy. Not the workout mode yet.
It's easy to lead that shit than to follow that shit. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, you can, like, I can lead this shit and do it comfortably and do a good job of this shit, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, this shit easy as hell. Like, because it's kind of like you just do you. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm just doing me and people just kind of like it and shit, though.
Like, I was hearing Gucci do this interview the other day where he was talking about it and he was saying, he's like, I like whatever the kids are into. Like, I don't give a fuck. He's like, even if I don't understand it, I'm going to try to understand it, you know? And it's like, that's crazy because that is, like, definitely the right attitude for an older guy in the industry. But, I mean, like, I wouldn't say you're at that point by far.
Yeah, no. But that is the way to think about it, though. Like, you can't go against the grain, though. Like, all the shit that's popping right now, though, even though you might not understand it.
You
shit is
put
working.
In the effort to actually listen to the shit and try to understand it for sure. Yeah,
if you don't, you still gotta respect it though, cause it's working for somebody though.
Yeah,
these niggas shows be going ridiculous, bro. Mm-hmm. Like, shit, and then on top of that too, shit. When I look at all this shit, and I really look at like all the people that really be mad at people like about the music they making, shit. I be like, bro, what are you mad for, man? Like, these people ain't out here robbing nobody, ain't killing nobody, they ain't doing shit.
Right.
They doing the simplest thing they can do. You know what I'm saying? Like, making music. It don't matter what it sound like or what it is, bro. Let it rock. If they making money from it, though, let them do what it do. Everybody got their opinions, though, but don't be mad at it, though. You got to respect. You got to respect the grind, though, period, though, at the end of the day. That's how I look at it, though. All the young niggas, even if they making this weird-ass shit, if it work,
do you
fuck
not understand
it, bro.
Yachty? Is Yachty kind of a mystery to you?
No, I fuck with Yachty, bro. Because, bro, I fuck with McConey.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
They are similar, right?
Yeah, you know, in my eyes, though, you know what I'm saying? Like, he kind of like a derivative of McConey, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? But he, like, kind of, like, goddamn super, like, he, like, 2.0. He, like, he doing his thing, though. I understand it. I understand all the young nigga shit, you know what I'm saying? I'm just saying, like, for, like the older people who don't understand that shit though. If, even if you don't understand it, the one thing you got to do is respect like what these niggas is doing though.
Right.
And they putting their little niggas on too though. You know what I'm saying? So.
I just thought one name that we'd be super, super negligent if we didn't mention it in terms of his career too. It's like our favorite rapper, Chief Keef.
Oh yeah.
Putting
work
with him too. That's crazy. Like we, that says a lot that we could easily have like left that out and it would just be.
I was waiting to bring that up. Too.
Yeah, Chief Keef, the homie, bro. That's like my bro. Like, that's like really the bro. Like, I fucks with him heavy though. You've
chilled with him in real life and like everything, or is it mostly an email relationship
I didn't chill with him in real life. Cool as fuck. Like, he cool as hell. Like, FaceTime and all type of shit. He, like, cool. Like,
he seems like he would FaceTime a lot.
Yeah, but you know his company has sued us.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Why is that?
Man, you're going to have to look that shit up, though. But
I will look that up. That's like, interesting.
Yeah, they had sued. Like, they did some shit, though. But, yeah, it's just kind of weird right now. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's cool, though, but it's weird right now, though, but.
I'm gonna have to do my Googles on that one. That sounds very
Google
interesting.
Google,
yeah, it was all public, like documents. Like, I found out online and shit, though. Like,
damn, really?
I didn't think the shit was real.
Over some beat shit? Like, sued over music stuff?
Yeah.
Oh, are you talking about that fucking company that he signed with?
Yeah.
Oh, and the niggas
he did the virtual shit?
Yeah, because they got, it's that dude, David, whatever, the billionaire, and he, like, got mad because they signed Keith to this contract, and then he put out a bunch of mixtapes, and then they're trying to get the money back from the shit.
We didn't have anything to do with, like, none of that. We just got caught in the mix. Everybody got sued.
Just because you made the beats, you got caught in the mix?
Listen, this is how crazy shit was. Everybody got sued except for Chief Keef, though. You know? Yeah, like.
You probably have to end up in all kinds of bullshit that you don't want to deal with because of music industry shit, huh?
I mean, shit, come with it, bro. Come with the territory, bro. Shit. I'm happy for it, though. But Chief Keef the homie, though, still. Like we still can do shit, though, but we just got to figure out certain shit, though. Like, I ain't gonna lie, me and him made like some hard ass shit. Like, man, we still got records too. Like, hard, just like hard. Like, we just bringing out the best of like each other and shit though. Like,
off top.
Like, we was going crazy. Like,
snap, bro.
Like, man, going crazy. But then, you know, that little situation kind of like just holded it though. Then, like, you know, like his fans be hitting me up all the time. Though, I want to put the shit out though, but. Shit, I ain't trying to get in trouble or nothing.
Quit fucking with these billionaires.
Nah, exactly. I ain't even got the money to play with them, bro. Just to make these people happy.
For real.
Mm-mm.
Well, hey. You know what? I still haven't said the biggest artist that he ever worked with.
Oh shit.
Beyonce.
Oh yeah.
You said that earlier.
We skimmed over it.
Yeah. How the fuck did that happen?
Yeah, that was on some. Right place, right time type stuff. So, I was just telling Jules about this story too. So a lot of people don't know about this shit though either though. But the way the record had came out, you remember on that bow down song?
Yeah, yeah.
And then
it had the end part. On
yeah,
it.
The
That's
end
the part
of,
you produced, right?
Yeah, I did the end part on it though. But people thought the Hit Boy produced it. You know what I'm saying? Because like he did that on the bow down. You know what I'm saying? So people didn't know like when that song switched up that it was a different producer and stuff either though too. So. It was me, Timberland, Polo the Don, and another producer named Keys who produced on that record and shit.
That one song?
Mm-hmm.
Damn.
And so like, but I had got the original stuff though. Like, Polo. This is the first day I met Polo. Like the song was originally supposed to be for Rihanna. And then we sent it to her too late or whatever. And then I had the sample and shit though. And then I had the drums and shit to it though. And that's I sent it back over and then they added all that shit to it and the shit came out.
It just came out, you weren't super involved with it?
But. Yeah, you know, like man, like them situations like it was like you already gonna be kinda distanced from them situations anyway. So like I wasn't expecting to get in the studio with Beyonce or nothing like that though. Right. You know, I was just reaping the benefits from it though, like you know, like shit, like I was just the conversation that we having about it though. That's what I did it for. You know what I'm saying?
It's a nice one to be able to say you did. Yeah.
Exactly. It was like I did it. You know what I'm saying? Like you know what I'm saying? I'm pretty sure we'll run across that hump again though, and I'm pretty sure I'll be in the studio with Beyonce like someday again, and it'll be something cool just to even tell her.
Yeah.
You know, like you never know. You know.
Yeah, you probably don't remember, but here's what I did.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, like it's cool. I got a cool little career. I'm just taking it day by day. I ain't in no rush.
Well, hey, we just covered an expansive hour and 40 minutes of the, of your career. Is there anything else we should talk about? Anything we're missing out on? Anything coming up that you want to mention?
Yeah, the Hennessy Project.
The Hennessy, yeah, what is that? They see you using the hashtag nonstop.
Yeah, motherfucking Hennessy reached out to me, and so we did. It's like a little sponsorship that we doing. And okay. So
thought you loved it. I was like, man, this guy really out here drinking. Yeah, I mean, do too.
Yeah, yeah. Like yeah. We like
that's
crazy.
That's the shit.
Hennessy changed my life, man. Yeah, it changed my life, man. My life.
So they reached out, and what kind of project are you doing with them?
All right, so. They wanted me to do, because they mess with me on the artist end, too. And uh-huh. So they want me to do a project, like, telling, like, well, a project of me, like, being an artist and me rapping over my beats and stuff, though.
Oh, really?
But it's kind of like a story of me going from producer to artist and stuff, though. It's kind of like, that's what the documentary based on.
Oh, okay,
you know
cool.
What I'm saying? There's a documentary attached to it, like a little small, mini little documentary.
Uh-huh.
And so that's basically what it is, like, the transition from that to that, you know what I'm saying? And that's, and, like, basically, like, everything I talked about today put into that project, plus like some more though. But it's only four songs, though. It's an EP. And so I was trying to push for more tracks on it though, but they was only like able to do four. And uh-huh. So I got like a lot of extra tracks and shit. So I'm just gonna start dropping these shits like in between and after, you know what I'm saying? I got videos and stuff ready and stuff for it though. So I'm going to drop the project on October the 1st, though, this Saturday coming up, I believe it is, though.
Wow, okay.
Yeah, I'm going to drop it. That's the date that they had chose, though, too. So, you know, we're kind of moving fast, though, but, you know, I'm kind of glad that we're moving fast, though, because, like, it's time for some shit to come out, though, from me, yeah. Though. And, like, I'm at a point, though, like, where I can put out shit, though, and people going to listen, like, I'm down there like my own little blog site on my own and shit, though. You know,
once
like,
you get that audience at a certain point, it's got to feel good, right, that you can get an audience on whatever you want to put out?
Kind of sort of are mine, you know, it's my audience though, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's everybody got their own little audiences and stuff though, but you know, I got mine though, so. But like today, I put out a song right before I came here. I was on the way here, I put a song out, yeah.
What's that called?
Don't Play.
Don't Play? All right, yeah, I gotta look that up.
Yeah, it's with Juicy J and Sizzle on it.
Oh, wow, yeah, Sizzle's fire.
Yeah,
he's
bro.
He's crazy as a rapper.
Yo, I think he gave me one of his hardest verses, like when I started, like, that's the best part about it too, cause I can be a producer though too while I'm an artist though. Like right. That's just like opened up so many doors. So
this
like,
is on your SoundCloud?
I just put it up today. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
nice.
I just put it up, so it's on. Ah, then I gotta make it. I meant to put it in the spotlight. That's what I meant to do.
There
can
you
just charge it right quick, bro?
Yeah. The fucking spotlight, man. The spotlight is such a problem on there. People always forget to put their shit there, and they put out a new mixtape, but you can't find it.
Yeah, it should be like different and shit though, but yeah, I just put that shit out, and that shit like already doing well. I did that right before I came here, you know, like, but that's on that was one of the songs that was gonna be on the project though, but like I said, I had to slim it down though.
Yeah,
but I'm still gonna put out the songs and stuff though, because I don't want to deprive people of anything though. I feel like I'm cutting them short or anything though, so
hell yeah,
I'm gonna put out like a couple songs before, and then I'm gonna put out the project and put something out after though.
That's
then,
what's up.
Yeah, I got the videos ready too. I had this one girl shooting these videos for me though. I call her Bane. She from Baltimore.
Uh-huh.
She dope. She shot two videos for me though. One on Pretty Fire though. So I really can't wait to put videos out though.
That's dope.
Yeah, so. Huh. Yeah, so that's coming out October 1st though. And so
Sonny rolling grams of wax. That's my new favorite song as of today. I was just watching that video and I was like, I love this song.
That was a fun song. Appreciate it, bro. Like that was fun though. Like the artist stuff that just kinda like let me have fun though. You know what I'm saying? Like I'm having fun now. I'm cool, you know what I'm saying? As long as I can make money from doing this too, and like which I'm able to do now, so
for sure.
I'm cool, you know what I'm saying? Now I just gotta maximize on this shit. Don't really go hard like I did with the producing though.
Yeah.
It's easy though. I just gotta just do this shit.
That's what's up.
You know what I'm saying? So yeah.
Does anybody you wanna send shout outs to before we wrap this up?
Shit, shout out to my boy Webb right here.
Yeah, shout out Webb, rolling blunts over here. Rolling blunts on wax.
Yeah, Webb over here. He's the next producer. I'm gonna have him in the West Coast on lock, man.
All right.
Him and his boy G Perico out here going crazy. Shout out to Mia over there in the corner.
Shout out to Mia.
You dig? Shout out to Mia in the corner. Shout out to my mother.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
Shout out to Pedro.
Yeah, yeah, thank you to Pedro for setting this up. Pedro, shout out Fool's Gold in general, man.
You know, yeah, shout out to Key.
Did y'all go? Did you go? Yeah, I did. Thanks for the invite, bro.
I left before I saw Ariana Grande, though.
I seen her.
Yo, fuck you, my
I
nigga.
I got Beacon in. I only...
y'all niggas.
Niggas am I supposed to get
bro,
there?
Niggas is... Y'all see how niggas do niggas, bro? Niggas ain't even mention that one.
I went up there for a second. It was straight. Last year was a lot.
Yeah, like, last year was straight.
Yeah, last year was lit, bro. Last year was lit. But this year was cool.
What's up? You got any festivals and shit you playing this year?
I don't know. Like, I did all that shit in London.
Yeah.
Or the UK and shit.
How was that?
Oh, my gosh, bro. I was there. That shit was like... I can't really explain it, bro. I don't really want to go out the country right now, though. That's what I can really say, though. But it was fun, though.
You know what I'm saying? You like need like a little break from it.
Man, bro, just imagine being in like, you know how we in the United States, but it's like almost like everybody speak English here, though.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like it's standard English, though. Like in the is it the UK?
Yeah.
The whole UK or Europe or wherever I was at. All Europe.
But they can fly in so easy to the music fest and shit, right?
Yeah, they can though. But this is the biggest problem. Like it's like so many different like places or countries inside of Europe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they speak different languages, but they like right next to door to each other and shit though. And so like you might like go here to here, and they might be it might be a whole different language. Streets might turn a whole different way or something like that. And imagine doing this like every day.
Yeah.
And we doing this on the train. We don't understand the languages, and like we got these bags with us. And then it's like we rushing like last minute onto the stage. Like we barely making it on the stage. Like, but it all paid off. Like it was fun though. Like that really made me feel like I had a job. Like I was like on my job type shit though, like nigga was running across the country like get to these shows, bro.
Yeah,
I went from fucking Amsterdam back up to fucking Paris and man, all over, bro.
It's like
taking flights,
planet,
trains,
you know?
Bro, it's crazy going through the border, like different borders. Like
I got on a flight for an hour. I'm in like San Francisco or like Vegas. It's like basically the same place in comparison. Yeah. Now there, it's like you could be in London and then you could be in Spain.
Yeah.
Amsterdam or whatever.
Yeah, bro, it's crazy though. But yeah, that shit was crazy. I ate pizza the whole time. Just to be on the safe side, cheese pizza too.
Pizza was just simple. Saving your life, bro.
Yeah, bro, that's the only thing that you can really like understand and be like.
Like I know this is gonna be good.
Right? Yeah, like I ain't gotta worry about it though. But thank them for having me though. I appreciate them. Every show was turned up. Paris was one of the most turned.
Yeah.
Germany was one of the most turned too because they
he's
had the backwoods.
Mini dabs as he says it.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, I got to shout out everybody like Splash Festival turned.
Amazing.
Flatbush Zombies, they was out there turned. Yeah.
Shout out to the Zombies. They need to come through.
Yeah.
Fuck, thank you so much for coming through. We just did an hour and 50 minutes, so this is probably the most comprehensive interview you ever did, I'm guessing.
Nah, I'm cool. I'm happy. Okay. I'm glad you knew everything. It's a lot more, though, too.
Yeah? All right, well, part two next time. Well, you come through a queue next time. We can do it together. That'll be fire.
That's any time, man. We can bring that together in any time. Like,
let's do it.
Hey, that's whenever.
Y'all nigga. Yeah.
Thank
you very much, Sonny Digital. Thank you, Lil House Phone, for co-hosting. This has been No Jumper, the coolest podcast in the world. Check us out on YouTube, SoundCloud, and iTunes, and subscribe.
Chill.
Peace.
I had to put it there so fast. I forgot to say, you're standing on the wall and shit. Yeah, I felt bad for you when you were standing up there for like an hour, and I wanted to be like, oh, you don't have to stand there. I didn't know if you felt that you had to stand there.
Oh, no, it's okay. All
right, I was like, okay.
No,
because
I don't know what to do with this part. Yes, I forgot that. I repeat all the information and then I don't know how to do this part. That's why I really was in it.
I ain't been this way.
Okay, so